Good evening, sports fans, and welcome to Wrightstown High School, the site for tonight's Northeastern Conference matchup between the visiting Freedom Irish and the host Wrightstown Tigers. It's another USA Today Network Wisconsin digital live stream, and we are here again in Wrightstown on homecoming night. A big NEC matchup, and my name is Ricardo Arguello, hanging out as always with Brett Christopherson. Jim Rosendick's bringing you those high-definition shots, and Brett, we haven't been to Wrightstown in a while, and we can't think of a bigger matchup to have when you're talking about Wrightstown and Freedom in any sport, especially in football.
And homecoming night to boot, Ricardo. So a big Week 5 game and a key game, right? Freedom coming in with a couple losses in a row, and Wrightstown with a loss last week to Xavier, its first setback of the season, so a chance to right itself. We talked about it before, Ricardo. You know, now we're in Week 5. We're going to be halfway through the season, over halfway through the season. Now it's that jockeying, right, and playoff positioning, Freedom wanting to keep itself in the playoff contention,
right,
and Wrightstown wanting to make sure that it gets a very good playoff seed and keeps itself in contention for a conference championship. So it's a big game here at Wrightstown High School, big Week 5 rivalry matchup. Looking forward to it, especially being homecoming.
Yeah, we're expecting a playoff atmosphere because both these are two teams that have had a lot of success in the postseason. We'll mention more about that later in the live stream. But we'll start off with some notes from both teams. I'll start with Wrightstown. Brett will follow with Freedom. Brett Christopherson putting together these notes so nicely every week. We appreciate it. But what do we know about Wrightstown? Well, they're 3-1 coming into tonight's game overall, 1-1 in the NEC. They're ranked 10th in Division 5 in this week's WISSports.net State Coaches Poll. They're coming off, as Brett mentioned, the 37-20 loss to Xavier last Friday in a Northeastern Conference and Bay Conference crossover game at Rocky Blyer Field in Appleton. That loss was the first of the season for the Tigers, who surrendered 3 fourth-quarter touchdowns to the Hawks to turn a tight game into a 3-score setback. Now, Wrightstown had a big night with its running game, producing 217 yards on 45 carries. Peyton Vandehei led the way with 137 yards and a touchdown, 14-yard score in the third, and he finished with 22 carries. Quarterback Trevor Vandehei was next with 60 yards on 14 attempts. He was credited with a 35-yard scoring run in the second quarter. Now, Trevor Vandehei, he also threw for a touchdown, 27-yard hookup with Jaden Kitto. That's right, Kitto in the opening quarter, and finished with 88 yards through the air on 5 of 11 passing. Kitto caught 3 passes for 56 yards on the night. Defensively, Quade Thompson and Landon Helfrey, they posted 12 and 10 tackles, respectively. Wrightstown was unable to slow down Xavier's rushing attack, though, as the Hawks finished with 283 yards and 5 scores. On the season, Trevor Vandehei has thrown for 98 yards but has only completed 20 passes. He has completed two of those. He's attempted 20 passes. He's completed two of those and has a touchdown and 2 picks. Aiden Humphreys, he leads the Tigers' run game with 445 yards and 4 scores. He's averaging a whopping 10.6 yards a carry and 148.3 yards per game. Vandehei is next with 360 yards and 5 touchdowns. He's averaging 7.8 yards per carry and an even 90 yards per game. If you're getting a clearer picture here on Wrightstown, they like to run the football.
Yes,
this
always
is
have,
the team
right?
has always centered its offensive attack with the run game. Well, we talked about Peyton Vandehei rushing for 231 yards and 3 touchdowns. Helfrey, he's also over 100 yards in the season with 102 yards and a pair of scores. Kitto is Wrightstown's top receiver with 3 receptions for 56 yards and a score. And on the defensive side, Helfrey is the team leader in tackles with 33. He also has 5 tackles for a loss. Now, Trent Vandehei has been credited with 3.5 sacks to lead Wrightstown in that category. Now, as a team, Wrightstown averaging 35.2 passing yards per game. They're allowing 76.5. They're averaging just a shade under 300 rushing yards a game at 291, and they're allowing 193.5. Overall, in terms of point totals, they're averaging 30.25 points a game and allowing 16.5. Brett, with my UW-Milwaukee math, that's nearly a healthy 14-point difference. The next game for Wrightstown, they're at Denmark. That's next Friday, an NEC matchup, kickoff scheduled for 7 o'clock. Brett, what can you tell me about the Freedom Irish?
Hey, Ricardo, Freedom 2-2 overall, 0-2 in the Northeastern Conference. Irish coming off a 24-14 loss to Winneconne last Friday. That was a Northeastern Conference Bay Conference crossover game last Friday down at Winneconne. The setback, second straight for Freedom, kind of a rarity in recent seasons. Freedom, which surrendered 8 sacks, committed 2 turnovers, and was held to 216 yards. Both, of the Irish's touchdowns came in the third quarter on a pair of runs from Noah Heinke. The first was a 1-yard plunge, the other a 6-yard scamper into the end zone. That made it a 17-14 game in favor of the Wolves, who ultimately secured the victory with a one-yard touchdown run later in the third quarter that capped the scoring and gave them a 10-point advantage. Quarterback Drew Courts threw for 98 yards, 9 of 23 passing in the loss. Heinke finished with 145 yards rushing on 18 carries. Heinke also led the way in receiving yards with 41, while Jack Bonnet posted the most receptions with 3. 6 different Irish players, by the way, credited with catches. On the season, Courts has thrown for 875 yards and 9 touchdowns while completing 55% of his passes. He has a 108.6 passer rating. His passing yardage leads the conference and ranks 17th in the state in all divisions. Heinke, the Irish's top rusher with 326 yards and 4 touchdowns. He's averaging 5.6 yards per carry and rushing for an average of 81.5 yards per game. Carson Clausen, he's the team leader in receptions with 15 and receiving yards with 294, which ranks 2nd in the league. Owen Whedon's 4 touchdown receptions, that leads Owen Wadeen's 4 touchdown receptions lead the way there. As a team, Freedom averaging 218.8 passing yards per game, allowing 115.2. The Irish are averaging 118 rushing yards per game and allowing 161.2. And taking a look at the scoreboard, Ricardo, Freedom averaging 23.5 points per game and allowing 25. Up next for the Irish, doesn't get any easier. They're at home next Friday night. Luxembourg Casco coming to town. Northeastern Conference matchup. Kickoff is scheduled for 7 p.m.
We're a few minutes away from the start of tonight's game. Again, Freedom at Wrightstown Football NEC matchup. Homecoming for Wrightstown. I'm just updating my Twitter. You can follow me at Ricardo, R-I-C-A-R-D-O, Deleon, D-E-L-I-A-N, all one word, at twitter.com, or I should say X. Am I right?
Yes, you are correct.
At
X Ricardo marks Deleon. The spot.
Yes. You can follow Brett at PC Bretzy, Rosie at Metal Rosie. Always nice to be here in Wrightstown. Brett, we've come here several times for basketball games.
It is nice.
The Tigers very strong in several sports, especially wrestling.
Fantastic people here. And we'll talk about that. We'll break up Wrightstown during the stream, Ricardo. And I just want to make mention, anybody watching tonight's game, we are not on Facebook tonight. So if you know of anybody trying to access the game on Facebook, Facebook just is not – there seems to be a glitch with Facebook trying to connect with what we're doing, and that's out of our control. However – watching it on postcrescent.com, greenbaypressgazette.com, and also, even more importantly, our USA Today Network Wisconsin YouTube page. So definitely check that out. We'll talk more about the game and everything else associated with the game in a moment.
Singing our nation's national anthem, the Star Spangled Banner, the cast of the Wrightstown musical, Grease.
Thank you.
Again, folks, not on Facebook tonight. Not our choice. Ricardo, Facebook not connecting with Vimeo, apparently.
I thought you had Zuckerberg on your email.
Oh, it's frustrating.
Why don't you text him? You have his number.
But we encourage anybody that if they're looking for the game, we're on USA Today Network Wisconsin YouTube channel, so you can find it there. Actually, we get quite a few views on YouTube and Postgres.com and GreenBayPressGazette.com. They're free links, so you should be able to have no problem finding the game in other platforms, I guess is what I'm trying to say. Hey, Ricardo, I want to thank our season sponsors, as always, Cellcom and Cooney's Embroidery and Sportswear. Cellcom's great smartphone event is going on now through October 1st. Get up to $900 when you activate a new line. Savings available on a variety of phones, including top brands. Visit cellcom.com/save for details. And get your team, club, or business name out there with Cooney's. They customize products specifically to fit their customers' needs. Delivery service is available. Contact them today at 920-731-0922. You can also send them an email at Cooneys, C-O-O-N-E-Y-S, 0922 at sbcglobal.net. Beautiful night to week five, Ricardo.
Gorgeous, as we're seeing these starting lineups being announced for both teams.
Can you believe we'll be past the halfway point of the regular season after tonight's games?
I can't believe it.
Flies by, doesn't it?
And also on tackle number 78, Hunter Vanderheiden.
It goes by quick, Brett. You're still in shorts.
And I refuse to give in to Mother Nature.
It's
a beautiful night, though. And Rosie's with us tonight, too. I thought maybe he'd be outside, but the threat of rain brought him inside.
Okay. We welcome him. You know we like hanging out with Rosie.
By the way, I want to thank the athletic director here at Wrightstown High School, Craig Hayes. Always appreciate him and the accommodations. Always rolls out the red carpet for us, and they're just so appreciative, too, of the coverage, and I just appreciate them. Always love coming here to Wrightstown. And you took the racetrack in Highway 41. Rosie and I took the nice scenic way through countryside.
I'm not familiar with that way, so didn't want to tempt fate and get lost. You never know, Brad. I have a terrible sense of direction.
Yeah. It's a pretty easy spin from my house down here to Wrightstown. Maybe takes 15 minutes tops.
No, I could have just taken, I guess, Northland all the way out here, huh?
Now, I don't know about Northland.
Well, double O, I thought maybe.
Linebacker, a 6-foot, 195-pound junior, number 35, Aiden Humphrey.
We also apologize to the Wrightstown folks if our wagon is still down there in the crowd somewhere. Hopefully we can find it after the game.
Oh, no.
Some it's down there somewhere.
Rosie.
We were too busy. But no, you can't take Northland and Ricardo. You got to take, this is your sense of direction. You're pointing east down Highway 96, which
that's
takes you to Denmark.
96.
You thought that was the way to freedom.
I thought so,
which is
yeah.
The opposite way.
I told you, I don't know.
That's okay.
Who do I think I look like, Christopher Columbo?
But definitely good to be here, and this would be a good game. Ricardo, I got some facts and figures. It's been a long, long time since the Irish have lost three straight games. Definitely one of the Northeastern Conference powers. These two teams are Northeastern Conference powers in recent years. I would say with Little Chute as well. Little Chute has made some deep playoff runs and one of our core leagues, right, along with the Fox Valley Association. So it's nice to kind of come down and check out these two fine programs.
Well, we're expecting a good one tonight, BC.
Yeah, and it looks like the wind kind of settled down. It was very, very windy earlier today, which Freedom, at least the first 2 weeks, their quarterback, Quartz, was really lighting it up, one of the state's top passers, and I thought, you know, obviously a heavy pass-oriented type team would the weather play a factor, but the wind has really calmed down, so that's good. We're going to see both teams' strengths at full display tonight, or Freedom's ability to throw the ball downfield, and of course, there's no secrets, right? Wrightstown, run, and run some more.
You know, Brett, I thought I looked on my weather bug, and it didn't say there'd be rain today, but...
There was a threat of rain earlier, and we just thought with all this fancy equipment.
Fancy schmancy.
We didn't want to take any chances.
Rosie having to jerry-rig some sort of a cover last second.
Kind of like we did at Menasha. Was that week two when they finally called the game? Wrightstown's going to kick off here to start this homecoming game. Talking to Craig Hayes, the athletic director, I said, how in the world do you schedule maybe your most bitter rival for homecoming night? Just the way the schedule worked out.
But, you know, there can be positives to that, Brett. You know the kids will be focused, right, because of the rivalry between the two teams.
Absolutely. Long-time rivalry. I got series, some information how far back this rivalry goes. Aaron Hamble, number 4, and number 18, Noah Heinke, back to receive the opening kick here at Wrightstown High School. Great crowd here on hand. Not surprising to see that. A new look at Freedom 2 with Charlie Jaden, the new head coach. Looks like Heinke's going to take it. Ooh, bobbles it, holds on to it, and he's off to the races. Let's see.
Finds a
rail. Return. He goes, and he's still on his feet. Cuts it outside over the 50 into Wrightstown territory. Ricardo, a great run, some good blocking. He really read that lane well.
You know, kick returning sometimes an undervalued trait on football teams, Brett, but he's able to now set up his offense in great field position, Brett, to start this game. Ball will be marked at the 44.
So first down at the 44-yard line in our first look at the Irish offense. And going deep downfield right away. Courts looking.
Overthrew everybody there, Brett, did Courts. Brings up a second and 10 again from the 44. Just underway here at Wrightstown High School. Rivalry game between the visiting Freedom Irish and the host Wrightstown Tigers, Northeastern Conference matchup.
Ricardo, I know the intended receiver is number 7. I don't see a number 7 on our program. And quick snap and not much there for who's got the ball there. That's number 18, Heinke, with his first carry of the game. So third and 9, and again, back to the line, Courts and the Irish. And we're going to get, I think, a procedure call. Yep, false start. We'll back up the Irish. So third and 9 becomes third and 14, playing behind the sticks after that great opening kickoff. Yeah, I'll have to get a name for number 7. I don't know if you got something over there.
I'm going to see if maybe if I can talk to Mr. Verbeaten over there, Coach Verbeaten.
Yeah, the wrestling coach. All the coaches here. Talk to Corey Hayes a little bit. He's on the staff, the head boys basketball coach. He's not ready to talk hoops yet. I don't blame him. Still good weather and still football time as Courts now on the run. He's going to reverse it back for a screen just short. Short on that. Try to set up the screen and nothing doing there. So fourth down coming up.
Brett, number 7 is Jack Bonnet.
Jack Bonnet. Okay.
And is he even on the roster as another number? I don't even see him on there. But okay.
We got it. So Ricardo, after that great opening kickoff, kick return, Freedom going to have to punt it away. So good job by the Wrightstown defense. Ooh, almost was short. Almost just mishit, I think, and darn near blocked at the line of scrimmage. Lucky he got it through. Again, if you know anybody looking for the game on our Press Gazette or Post Crescent Facebook pages, unfortunately, there's just some sort of a Facebook glitch going on tonight that is not allowing, I guess, Facebook to play nice with Vimeo. So out of our control, unfortunately. We apologize, though. But you can watch it. You can tell everybody it's on postcrescent.com, greenbaypressgazette.com. Also, again, our USA Today Network Wisconsin YouTube channel. You can subscribe to that channel. So that's the beauty, Ricardo, of streaming to multiple platforms. If one isn't playing nice, there's other ways to watch. There's your first handoff of the game. And fumble! Let's see who came up with it. Nope, official saying second down. And I think that was number four. Was that Daniel Bunton, maybe, the sophomore running back with the first carry?
Minimal yards gain, but I think a bullet dodge, though, Brett, with that fumble recovery.
Were you watching that Thursday night game last night, Eagles and Vikings? My goodness, the Vikings having some turnover issues.
Right.
They have 7 turnovers in the first 2 weeks of the season. Packer fans aren't going to be too upset about that. Bears fans either, right, Ricardo?
We love it. Second down and 9 at the 28. Tigers with that power offense, running offense, I should say, up the near side and still on his feet.
Trevor Vandehei, the quarterback, a junior. And if you're going to be a running team, it's nice to have a running quarterback to boot. And they got a whole bunch of guys that can run the football. We kind of talked about it in the open. You got Trevor Vandehei with 360 yards rushing. Aiden Humphreys, he has 445 yards coming. And then you have Peyton Vandehei, 231. And Landon Helfrey with over 100 yards on the season. So four runners with over with 100-plus yards on the ground so far this season. Third and short coming up for the Tigers. What do you think they're going to do here, Ricardo?
Run.
Vandehei, well, we're going to get out. What are we going to get here? I think it was a delay of game. Nope, timeout.
Brett, just an update. Peyton Vandehei is not playing. I can see him there on the sidelines, and I was told that before the game. Rosie, if you see him right down there, right towards the 30-yard line, he's in shorts. Peyton Vandehei, one of their starting, to your right a little bit, right there. Thank you.
Looking at the rest of the Northeastern Conference tonight, Denmark at Fox Valley Lutheran. How about Little Chute at Luxembourg Casco?
Battle for LC.
Yeah, the LC sign. We'll keep an eye on that. Little Chute right now, along with the Foxes and the Spartans, all 2-0 in the Northeastern Conference standings. Other games of interest we're going to keep an eye on, of course, Appleton East at Kimberly. That's a big one. Kaukauna at Fond du Lac. Now, normally you wouldn't say an 0-4 Fond du Lac team, but they've been so close the last 2 weeks. Almost beat Kimberly last week. Almost beat Appleton North in a game we streamed in week 3. So that could be a very interesting matchup at Fondy and Notre Dame at Sheboygan North as well in the Green Bay Lakeshore area. Try it again. Vandehei waiting for the snap under center. And diving forward is Bunton for the first down. Getting a little rowdy here on homecoming.
They love it.
So first and 10, Wrightstown in no big hurry, had to burn a timeout before the delay of game penalty was called. So Vandehei waiting for it again. And whoa, high snap, good job just to stick with it. Vandehei looking for some room along that right side, dives forward, gets about 5 yards.
Could have gotten a lot more, Brett. I think there was a touchdown. Well, not touchdown, but a long play saving tackle. Because he had a rail to run through.
You know, Wrightstown plays that old school cut type football. You think think they'd ever get turf here?
Good question.
Should have asked Craig Hayes that, the athletic director here. I think the only school in the Northeastern Conference with turf is Little Chute. I don't believe anybody else has.
Yeah, that's a good question. I think you're right, Brett.
I know the FEL was looking into it a few years back. First handoff for number 28, Caden Colwell, the junior running back. And third down coming up.
Third and four situation coming up for Wrightstown.
I'd see Luxembourg Casco doing that at some point. Seems to be the way, right? All these... Nina and Fond du Lac, of course, with their new facilities, or new school. But turf fields for them after years on grass fields. So third down here in the opening quarter, homecoming night, week 5, Wrightstown trying to keep it itself in the conversation for a conference title. Vanderhei waiting for the snap. We'll talk about Trevor Vanderhei and what he's got coming up. Nice little play, and oh boy. Oh, we got a flag. I think it's going to be coming back, but a good little play design. That was Jaden Kitto, the junior running back, but Ricardo, a flag flying in the middle of that play.
And that flag is right around the 44 of Freedom, and it is a hold.
Actually, Ricardo saying block in the back.
Oh, it is a block in the back, right. I'm just trying to see where they're going to mark that off.
Right at the 50.
Oh, okay. I was going to say, now they place a flag right at midfield, and then they'll mark it off from there. So it'll be at the 40.
Yeah.
To bring up another, a third down and long now.
Right. 10 yards from the spot of the foul. So they'll try that third down run again, or maybe Vanderhei step back and
throw it.
Yeah, we'll see. He doesn't have a whole lot of attempts through the air. He's only attempted 20 passes coming in, 98 yards. Touchdown, 2 interceptions. We'll have to talk about his baseball prowess here.
Say, we know he has an arm.
Well, big-time arm. That's why he's one of the – well, he is the top prospect or a top high school baseball player in his class in the state. And I know he's going to tuck it in, and not much there. I'm going to try to get a number of the Irish defender. I think that was number 74, Freedom, getting in there. Henry Vanderheiden, 6'5", 230-pound defensive tackle. And Wrightstown will have to punt this one away. Thanks to everybody checking us out tonight. Again, no Facebook feed. Facebook
Zuckerberg.
Facebook not working with Vimeo. And I'll continue to announce that throughout the course of our stream here, out of our control. Rosie and I were on the phone with Vimeo for hours today. Look at that punt.
Taking it at the 10 and out right about the 17 or 18.
Yeah.
That's Hamble.
Yeah. Kind of wonder, did that have enough to skip into the end zone? I think Hamble made a good, probably a good decision. That could have just died inside the 5. So out to the 16-yard line. But flipping the field are the Tigers, so long field ahead for the Irish. But again, on our USA Today Network Wisconsin YouTube channel, a lot of people watch these games now on YouTube, Ricardo.
44-yard punt there for Wrightstown, Brett. And first down and 10 at the 16 for Freedom, starting their second offensive possession of the game. I think Quartz took it up the middle there.
Hey, look at Quartz now. He got off to a red-hot start this season.
He threw
for 430 yards and 7 touchdowns. That was a week one win against Wapaka, and then he followed that up with a 275-yard, 2-touchdown performance in a 30-0 blanking week two victory over Seymour. Since then, a little bit tougher for the yards to come by for Quartz. Ooh, big stiff arm. That was number 2, Carson Clausen, the big senior tight end, trying to gain some more yards. Pretty powerful kid, all-conference performer last year. But, yeah, then Quartz, I got it right here. Week 3, limited to 72 yards in that that rough game against Xavier. That was a 48-3 loss to the Hawks on September 1st, 2 weeks ago. In the last week, 98 yards for Quartz.
Fumble. Quartz not able to corral that snap, Brett, but looks like, I'm trying to see who was running. Heinke able to get whatever he could, the running back, out of that play.
Yeah, and that pass to Clausen was a first down. So, yeah, two blistering passing performances for Quartz in weeks 1 and 2. Now weeks 3 and 4 definitely have cooled off, but he's still among the leaders, you could say, in passing. And look at this. Wow, carrying the pile is number 18, Heinke again. Listed at 5'11", 150-pound senior running back, and that's going to move the sticks first down. I think we mentioned it in the game notes that Court's coming in. I know he is the leader in the Northeastern Conference. 17th in the state in all divisions coming in, 875 yards passing.
Nice cutback. That's Heinke.
Caden Colwell and Brendan Gustafson. Brendan Gustafson, a senior defensive lineman, 6'3", 250 pounds, one of the players in to bring down Heinke. Colwell listed at 5'11", 170-pound junior defensive back. Second down coming up.
Heinke, 4 carries, 17 yards early on in this game, Brett.
Court's going to take it. Looking downfield, and nice job defensively.
Thompson.
Yeah, Quade Thompson. Now, Bonnet Ricardo had a step or two on Thompson, but Thompson with some closing speed at the last second. 6-foot linebacker going against the wide receiver. Was able to chase that down and just get a hand on it to knock it away.
He was extending that full 6-foot frame, Brett, to knock that away, or that would have been a sizable gain.
Good little play design, and it was there. But Thompson making an athletic play, so third down coming up for Courts and the Irish.
Third and a long five, we'll call it six.
Courts, little toss to Heinke, and oh boy, met a whole bunch of blue jerseys. I think number five, one of the first ones in there. Again, Quade Thompson. And fourth down, Irish going to have to punt it away. Button back to, or check that Hamble back to punt. Nice punt.
Wow, it took a Freedom bounce inside the 20, Brett. The big Kimberly-Appleton East matchup going on over there at Kimberly, Brett. Kimberly up 7-0 over Appleton East.
Yeah, the Patriots, Ricardo, we talked about Final Act being close, right, on a couple of those games. Same with the Appleton East. Could very well be undefeated. Lost to Menasha, was that week two, or was that week one?
Week one, by a couple points, and then week three we saw them, I shouldn't say we did, but one of our reporters, I mean, they were leading Neenah up until the fourth quarter.
Yeah, that's right, and probably should have taken them down, right? I'm thinking Fond du Lac last week against Kimberly.
Right.
Getting those these games mixed up. So, yeah, East kind of needs that signature win. I think we talked about that on the 920 Sports Podcast, but I never saw that linked on our sites this week, the 920 Sports Podcast.
Yeah, I have to get on that. I mean, I linked it through Twitter. Oh, X, I'm sorry.
Yeah, we got to get that on the website so everybody can check that out. And
who ran that? I did not see.
Did not catch a name. I might need to check these guys next door. But anyway, we're talking on our 920 Sports Podcast, formerly the R&B show, that's what Appleton East needs. I think that's the next step, right? You have to beat Anina here, have to beat an Appleton North, beat a Kimberly, beat a Kakana. Take that next step. Vanda High waiting for it. Another high snap. Good job to bring it down. And boy, Freedom playing some good defense, not allowing much in the way of running room for the Tigers.
You got to be encouraged by that if you're the Freedom side of the ball. You know, Charlie Jaden seeing his defense kind of struggle, Brett, the last couple weeks. Against Xavier, I believe, and then Winneconne beating Freedom.
Looking at that offensive front for the Tigers, Charlie Garvey. Is he on the roster? Yeah, Charles, yep, he's 6'4", he's number 67, the lone returning first-teamer in the league this season. That's Charlie Garvey. So running behind Garvey, here's their first pass attempt, and Vanderhyde just too strong. He had number 7 Kiddo there.
Brett, that was the right idea.
Yeah.
The right play call, just mistimed a little bit. Perhaps that's something they revisit later in the game.
Kind of a chess match, right? Sometimes, same with that little route that we saw along the sideline that Thompson was able to knock away. That was there, and maybe you try to run that again, talking about Freedom. instead. Another punt in this scoreless first quarter, homecoming night at Wrightstown High School. And beautiful punt. Whoa, tough catch for Hamble. And finally brought down. Gives me a chance to let everybody know we got a great deal on a digital subscription right now. Post Crescent, Press Gazette, any of our USA Today Network Wisconsin websites for the next 6 months. You can get all the benefits with a digital subscription for just $1. 6 months for $1. That's all it costs you for the next 6 months. Unlimited coverage, full access on your desktop, tablet, mobile devices every day, exclusive subscriber newsletters, the e-edition, USA Today Sports Plus app.
$1?
That's all for 6 months. You get all of that. Go to postcrescent.com or greenbaypressgazette.com/subscribe.
It's not much at all. You can't even go to the dollar store sometimes to get stuff for a dollar anymore.
Yeah, I know. Isn't that something? Courts with a handoff to Heinke. You mentioned Charlie Jaden, the first-year head coach for the Irish. He's a Freedom High School grad. Not that long ago, Ricardo.
No.
2017. Played quarterback for the Irish. His career total is 4,398 yards, 45 touchdowns. Included a stellar senior year in which he threw for over 2,300 yards, 22 touchdowns, a 117.3 passer rating.
What year was this graduation year?
2017, but
yes.
the season was 2016. Ooh, through the fingertips. Looks like it was Carson Clausen, the intended receiver. But Jaden, he was the Irish's co-offensive coordinator last season under Clint Krewalt. Now, Krewalt, I was just looking over there with my binoculars still on the staff, in an assistant role. So Charlie Jaden, was he maybe 20, 25 years old? 24, 25 years old, somewhere around there.
Well, he's a thrill to coach your alma mater.
Heinke, boy, oh. Some razzle-dazzle there on that far side of the field. Zigging and zagging his way to a first down. But got to be a thrill for Coach Jaden, right, to come back to your alma mater and take over really one of the stellar programs statewide, Ricardo, in Division Four.
Heinke, 7 carries, 35 yards. Numbers boosted a little bit by that 12-yard run and a first down. First down and 10 at the 40 for Freedom.
Little play fake, and there's a nice pitch and catch from Quartz to Clausen. I think Freedom last year, what, state semifinals, falling to Columbus in a pretty good game in the state semifinals. I think that was played in Ripon. And I believe, correct me if I'm wrong, Ricardo, I think Columbus ended up winning the state championship.
They did. They knocked off Catholic Memorial.
Nina, no problems right now over Oshkosh West. 21-0 Rockets with the lead still in the first quarter. So Rockets trying to bounce back after falling to Kokana last week. We streamed that one at New Rocket Stadium. Ooh. Aiden Humphreys, the junior linebacker, getting in there pretty hard against Hamble. But a first down for the Irish, and I'm guessing that Freedom's going to let this clock run out. And that Hamble run will indeed be the final play of the first quarter. So as we look at our Cellcom, Cooney's Embroidery and Sportswear scoreboard, scoreless first quarter here at Wrightstown High School. Long time Northeastern Conference, well, not even Northeastern Conference rivals. It goes back to the Olympian Conference days, and I don't even know what was the precursor to the Olympian. But these two teams have been playing for a long time. At halftime, folks, we got a lot to talk about. We have Ricardo's Elite 11, terrific teams to mention. And our Clubhouse Live show. We got our photographer, Bill Glashine. He's strolling up and down the sideline, so he's going to have photos of this game later on tonight on postcrescent.com and greenbaypressgazette.com. So definitely check out Bill's work. I'm trying to think where Dan Powers is tonight. Is he at the
might be at the Kimberly
East Apple and East game?
Let me tell you something. The East just pulled within 7-6 on an 87-yard run play.
Mm.
Patriots keeping it close so far against the powerhouse papermakers.
Now, at least no longer number one in the WIS Sports poll. In Division One.
Well, they're still in the Associated Press poll. They're still number one.
Number one until proven otherwise, right?
Yeah, I'm not sure why they're. Who was the number one in the coaches poll?
I'm trying to remember now. I have to go back and.
Because Kettle Moraine's Division Two.
And look, maybe just because it was a squeaker of a win against Fond du Lac last week, dropped him down, the coach's poll thinking. I don't know. Second quarter underway. Court's kind of bobbling it. Ooh. Heinke trying to find something and finally going to be driven out by number 84, Everett Lamers, the defensive back. I think Aiden Humphreys, the linebacker, was one of the first ones there to kind of slow that play down.
If the coach has got a ding Kimberly for losing against Fond du Lac, that means the coaches aren't in the know of how good Fond du Lac is, Brad.
Very good 0-14.
That means they weren't paying attention.
They're a good 0-4 team. It could be an 0-5 team, and they might not. A very good team that might not make the playoffs.
They've had the toughest schedule in the state. If you look at the combined win totals of their four and five opponents, they're going against undefeated Kaukauna tonight.
I think every opponent so far for Fond du Lac in the first 5 weeks has been state ranked.
Yes.
And highly ranked at that. It was Sussex, Hamilton, Franklin, Appleton. Well, Appleton North, I guess, wasn't. Appleton North should be, in my mind, a top 10 team.
I voted them in the top 10.
I mean, that's another mainstay in Division I. And then, of course, Kimberly and now Kaukauna ranked high in Division II or the medium division in the Associated Press poll.
Well, was this a face mask?
Yeah, it looks like it. Personal foul, okay, so personal first foul. Down. And a good scoring opportunity here for the Irish. Last time Freedom has lost two straight, Ricardo, was back in the 2021 season. Irish dropped back-to-back matchups against Denmark and Luxembourg Casco in weeks 7 and 8. Freedom actually went on then to advance to the state semifinals that season. Last time Freedom dropped three straight, I'll tell you all after this play. It's been a long time. As Court's now going to drop back on this first down play. He's flushed out.
Look
and
out.
He's dropped down. I think that's a sack.
They did. They're calling it a sack.
That's that 75 there. Braden Nowitzki.
Woo, 6 foot, 300 pounds.
Yeah.
Court sacked in the backfield by Nowitzki.
So bringing Court's down. Good coverage downfield. Court's nowhere to throw. And then Nowitzki just busting through into the backfield. Court's really had no chance. How about Nowitzki, Ricardo, the 300-pounder, showing his quickness as well.
You'll see, you know, and that's a loss of 9 yards, Brett. So second down and 19. This is exactly what Wrightstown need, especially following that penalty, Brett. Personal foul. Three receivers far side.
Yeah, Court's waiting for it now. He's going to roll right and look left. Nope, not there.
Oh, they sniffed that out.
Yeah, they did.
Tigers defense sniffed out that screen.
Yep, trying to get a little misdirection play. And now third and a long ways to go here for Courts. But the last time Ricardo Freedom has lost three straight, that was back in the 2010 season. It's actually a part of a five-game losing streak, Freedom finishing 3-6 that season. So we're talking 13 years ago since three straight losses. A very proud program, obviously, and again, one of the state's better programs in Division IV, both of these programs. Mainstays when it comes to state playoff runs. Of course, whoa, watch out. Fumbled snap, picks it up. And again, nowhere to go. He's scrambling, looking for some help. Going to loft it downfield and knocked away.
Caught!
Oh!
That Clausen?
Clausen with the catch.
It's a touchdown, Brett.
Is that 25 yards? What a play.
Touchdown, Freedom.
Wow. What a play by Clausen.
Brett, you got to give Courts credit for scrambling, getting that pass out. It was knocked away.
Yeah, it was knocked away.
By a Wrightstown defender and then right into the hands of Clausen.
Good concentration by Clausen. And what a score. What a way for our first touchdown of the game to be scored. Nolan Phillips, the place kicker, waiting for the PAT. Phillips, and that one's good. And as we look at our Cellcom Cooney's Embroidery and Sportswear scoreboard, the Irish now with the first strike. 7-0 lead for Freedom on that 25-yard hookup from Courts to Clausen. That was a heck of a throw. I mean, he's doing that on the run, being chased. Looked like he was running out of real estate there on that far sideline and just uncorked it. hoping that somebody could make a play that looked like the, like you said, a Wrightstown defender didn't get a number on it, knocked it down. I thought that was incomplete, but stayed in the air and lands in Clausen's hands in the end zone.
Again, we got to give Quartz credit, Brett, for actually just being able to get that ball off. He scrambled quite a bit on that play, went from one hash mark to the other. And then the concentration from Clausen as that ball was tipped right in his area as he was able to pull that down for the 25-yard score.
Well, let's see how the Tigers respond to that. As Kiddo with the return.
First down, Wrightstown, ball on their own 27-yard line.
Look at the season series, Ricardo, between these two programs. 35-30, Freedom with the lead. The Irish have won 10 of the last 12 meetings. The series started back in 1949.
Ooh.
It was a 19-7 Freedom victory right here in Wrightstown. So far, that Freedom defense really doing a good job against this Tigers rushing attack. Let's see what Vandehei does. Oh, wow. Who was that? Number 26 for the Irish. That's Nixon Heinke. There's just a sophomore. He's listed as a middle linebacker, outside linebacker, and just coming in. And no gain on that run.
Second and 10 from just short of the 27-yard line. Tigers. Bit of a counter there and goes nowhere. Freedom again, that interior. Staying very disciplined, Brett.
Yeah, this time number 25, Cooper Capert. Strong safety, 6'2", senior, 180 pounds, just getting in, filling the hole. And again, no gain. So third and 10, Ricardo, this rushing attack really spinning its wheels right now, having a hard time getting going.
Tigers trail 7-0, 25-yard touchdown from Quartz to Clausen, the game's only score.
Vandehei gonna let it fly,
oh,
going down
man.
Field. Ooh, just a little high. Kiddo, the intended receiver, was that Quartz, the quarterback back there? The free safety now. And a quick three and out, so good job by that Freedom defense.
Again, I think it was a good idea. I think just the ball needed to be placed better. Back to punt is Vandehei.
High punt, but short punt. And it's going to skip out of bounds at about the 45-yard line, 46-yard line. So good field position for the Irish, up 7. And the Freedom defense, Ricardo, just playing a whale of a game right now against that Tigers rushing attack.
Right, and Wrightstown had a nice opening drive that kind of ended at the 40 of Freedom. But, Brett, Freedom since then has really kind of locked down that rushing attack, though, of Wrightstown. We'll see what Quartz and company can do with a pretty good field position just shy of the 50. First and 10 at the 46 for Freedom.
Heinke with it. He's got some space. Nope. Good job. Oh, almost cut it inside. Number 84 for the Tigers, Everett Lamers, senior defensive back, doing a good job. I think Heinke wanted to bounce that outside, but Lamers wouldn't allow him to do that. He had to cut it in and gets a couple yards out of that. Yeah, 1949 was the first time they met, and the series was uninterrupted from 1949 through 1998. So every year these two teams played. Ooh, watch a fumble again. Quartz is able to pick it up. And he's still on the run, getting chased, looking down. There's going to be a hold coming back. Flag is down. Incomplete pass anyway is Luke Talbot, the intended receiver there, number 11, but they're going to get is that illegal man down? What was that? Catch that call.
See, the whatever it is, the Tigers coaching staff telling them to take them back.
Yeah, you got to push them back, right? So from 98, though, until the 2011 season, these two teams didn't play. Now, remember, I think Freedom then was moved, what was it, the Valley 8 and then Eastern Valley Conference for a while, and Wrightstown stayed in the Olympian.
Mm-hmm.
I know Wrightstown Brilliant, that's always been a pretty good rivalry, too. That Brilliant's not too far down the road. But that 11 season was a Tigers beat Freedom 42-9 in a Division IV first-round game. Then Wrightstown joined the newly formed Northeastern Conference in 2014 and has faced Freedom every year ever since. That's just too far for Talbot, and third and long, third and a country mile coming up here for Quartz. But yeah, longtime Olympian rivals. I'm trying to think of that league. Valders, Denmark, I think, was in that league.
It's just fun to hear the Michicott name Olympian again.
Yeah, Michicott. I want to say was in that league. Brilliant, as I mentioned. I don't think Chilton was in that league. All these smaller communities around here. It's always fun on a Friday night to check out how the towns come out to support their high school football team. Third and long for Quartz. Little pump fake. He's got all day.
He does. Way too much time.
Yeah, now he's going to be chased. Nothing downfield again. And that went through Clint Crewalt's hands. And some frustration, I think, for the Irish as well.
That just wasn't a very good-looking drive, Brett.
No, not at
Obviously
all.
Obviously, the penalty having a damaging effect on it. But also, you got to give the Tigers a little credit, Brett, doing a good job of covering the Freedom receivers.
Yeah, both defenses playing well. And, in fact, kind of an acrobatic-type crazy catch is what led to this first score. Ooh, short punt here. And that's going to stay.
That's going to be in
Freedom territory.
Didn't even make it past the 50. It's going to be at the 47, Brett, so a 14-yard punt.
But that 25-yarder from Quartz to Kloss, and remember that was knocked away by a Wrightstown defender into Clawson's hands. So even good defense leading to a touchdown there as Quartz was scrambling and on the run. Last time these two teams played was week five last year at Freedom, Irish beating Wrightstown 42-7. The Irish scored three touchdowns in the second quarter to open up a 29-7 halftime lead. Carter Creerall, remember him?
Oh, yeah.
147 yards and three touchdowns to lead Freedom. 297 rushing yards overall that night for the Irish. Hand off. Looks like that might have been number 30. Is that Landon Helfrey? The fullback, senior fullback.
Landon Helfrey on the carry.
Matt Weinberg, the Freedom quarterback, 129 yards and two touchdowns. Tigers limited to 99 yards rushing last year and 57 yards passing in the loss. Something I wanted to get your take on too, Ricardo. You know, we talk about the state rankings. We'll talk about that in a moment. We'll get this play underway. But something that caught my eye in the coaches' poll anyway. And what are we going to get here? Another pre-snap penalty?
Oh, boy. Wrightstown right now just shooting themselves in the foot if that's the case. Both offenses really a little bit disjointed.
But I noticed this, Ricardo. Wrightstown ranked 10th. In Division 5 in this week's WISSports.net State Coaches Poll. Traditionally, at least in recent seasons, the Tigers have been D4, well, maybe a D5 team this
those
year?
Those are all projections, I guess, by the coaches. You know, you never know until we realize how many teams are in D1 or in the playoffs and D2, right? Because they kind of format their the brackets from that.
Oof, there's a collision there, and there's Aiden Humphreys now with a carry. But that's going to be a pretty good D5 team if they indeed have to go down.
I agree.
I was looking at the enrollment. I'm a little surprised. Maybe those listening can fill me in. I'm at PC Bretzi on Twitter. But this is a growing community, right? Mm-hmm. I would think that enrollment would be going the opposite way since this is in between Appleton and Green Bay, and you see new subdivisions popping up here in town.
Real nice community.
Very nice. But
I'm a big fan of the Coca-Cola Distribution Center that's nearby.
Yeah, you gonna stop there on your way back?
I might have to.
Actually, my wife and I we celebrated our anniversary with a dinner in Wrightstown back in the spring downtown. Another penalty.
Oh boy!
Another procedure call on third down. Wow! And you can kind of hear upstairs at least the.
They're not happy.
The coach's box, they're
because these are mental mistakes. This is the kind of stuff that really hurts you. So now this goes from a somewhat manageable third and five situation to a third and nearly 10. And we know that throwing isn't something Wrightstown does a lot. And
I don't
think you have to, though.
I think you can try them. This could be four down territory
if you get a
good chunk play here on the ground. Let's see what the Tigers want to do. Nope, Vandehyde.
Oh, they got a guy open.
He's got it wide open is correct, and he would dives for the first down. Caden Colwell, the junior running back. It looked like number 19.
Is it a first down? It is a first down. Okay.
Owen Wadeen kind of hit the turf in frustration because Colwell just able to, at that last second, dive for the first down. So first completion of the night for Vandehyde.
Brett, that Kimberly score now is 14-6, Papermakers over the East Patriots.
Kind of what we're talking about again on our podcast, right? No maybe superstar team in the FBA this year?
Definitely every team has its warts.
Yeah. Oh, well, still on his feet. And he's going to go in for the score. 37-yard touchdown by Helfrey. Wow.
Well, let me tell you, Brett, that's why you do those squats. Mm. That's why you do the deadlifts and the clean and jerks. Strengthen those legs because he just powered his way through I don't know how many broken tackles.
Wow.
I think they called him the toolbox.
They did.
Here in the press box. But, boy, oh, boy, just running through arm tackles was Helfrey. We're looking at him down there on the sideline. He is pretty put together pretty well below the waist. You can see that those legs, tough kid to tackle.
Button in for the PAT. Bangs that one through. And as we look at our CELCOM Cooney's embroidery and embroidery and sportswear scoreboard, 7-7 the tie. Sorry, folks, just kind of jotting down some notes here. You have 37 yards, right?
I had 37 yards,
yes. 37-yard run, like Ricardo said. There were about two or three times I thought he was down. Then that last little lunge by the Freedom defender trying to grab those ankles, but those legs were churning, as you said, those big strong legs, the toolbox, as they call them. Landon Helfrey, 5'9", 190-pound senior fullback, just busting through the middle of that line, refusing to go down and tying this one up at 7 apiece. We've got a good Northeastern Conference battle going between these two rivals. Freedom will stay D4. Little shoot as well, but was kind of surprised to see Wrightstown's enrollment, at least on the WIS Sports site, low 400s.
Wow.
Oh, good hands there, kind of squibbing that one, and it bounced right into the hands of number three, Matthew Eberhardt. And a good field position for the Irish. I'm going to look again. Check out the Wrightstown enrollment, at least based on what they're listed on the Wisp Sports site. As Court's waiting for this snap. Ooh, nice spin move to break a tackle was Heinke. It's about four or five yards. Yeah, it says 402 is the enrollment. Seems awfully low, doesn't it?
It does.
Kind of a bigger school out here and nice facilities. So second down and about six to go for Quartz. He's kind of looking at that option pitch to Heinke. Nice little move. Boy, he's got
still on his feet.
Yeah,
as well.
He's a powerful runner, but he's really got the ability to make guys miss on his little jump cuts or just planting that little leg into the turf and just exploding the opposite way, going in and out. So a nice run by Heinke and a first down for the Irish in Wrightstown territory. Clock running.
Brett, I have 53 yards and 11 carries.
Gonna have to adjust our clock here, Rosie. We just move the camera a touch.
I didn't touch it, Rosie.
No, we'll move it after the play here. As Quartz now, he's got some time. Well, he got a long time. Gonna throw down field high. Double covered was Bonnet.
By the way, another big game going on in the southeastern part of the state, Brett. Muskego leading McWanago 17-7.
Mm.
I will say again that the whole Kimberly not being number one, they're number one in the AP poll, Brett. I think they got seven first place votes. I want to say Kettle Moraine is second.
Heinke. Not much room there. Whole bunch of blue jerseys bottling up Heinke. Third down coming up, under 4 minutes to play. Yeah, I agree with you, Ricardo. First, you're number one until proven otherwise. And the defending D1 champs.
Yeah, and it's not like Kimberly's some kind of flash in the pan.
Yeah.
You know, they've been doing this for years now.
They're the program in the state.
Third and 10 from the 43 of Wrightstown. Three receivers near side for Quartz.
Oh, flip play fake, Quartz. And let's see, pass is to Talbot. And where are they going to spot this? Going to be shy a couple yards. Four down territory, I got to think, right?
Yeah, 9 yard gain, so it'll be fourth and two, Brett.
Yeah, inside the 35. They'll see officially at the 34 yard line. Irish trying to keep this drive going as we approach halftime. Again, stick with us at halftime. A whole bunch of stuff to talk about. Very busy these days at the office. Quartz waiting for it. And that's going to be on Wrightstown, right? Yeah.
Well, again, that's another mental mistake if that's on Wrightstown.
Yeah, too many pre-snap penalties, so that's a free first down coming off the penalty. I'm imagining Steve Clister, longtime head coach for the Tigers, will be a point of emphasis at halftime.
2:40 left here in the second quarter, Brett. Right now, Freedom at the Wrightstown 29, new set of downs. Three receivers far side for Freedom.
Quartz. Ooh, behind, almost intercepted. Oh, wow.
Oh. You're not going to get an easier pick there. I'm trying to see who.
Well,
Bunton.
Bunton almost had it. Talbot was the intended receiver. Looked the throw was behind Talbot. Kind of popped in the air. And Bunton just couldn't secure the interception. So no harm, no foul for the Irish second
down. He's going to look at that film tomorrow morning, or whenever they see their film, and he's going to be kicking himself. That was an easy pick.
courts. Again, got some time, fires it over. Oh, Talbot now through the hands. And he kind of puts his head down like, I should have had that one.
It's a chant of Butterfingers going on by the Wrightstown student section.
So third and 10, we'll try it again.
Ball's not slick out there, is it, Brett? It hasn't
I don't think
rained
so.
At all.
No, just.
That's about the fourth or fifth time we've seen the ball careem off or carom off of a receiver's hands or defensive back's hands.
Courts again, quick to Clausen and incomplete.
Yeah, he couldn't secure the reception.
He did, and I think there was some pretty good traffic there in the middle of the field. It might have been a Wrightstown defender getting his hand in there to knock it away. But fourth down, so Irish would imagine inside the 30 down at the 29 will go for it here.
I was going to say it would be a short 40, not a short, but 42, 43-yard field goal. So, yeah.
You could punt it away if you wanted to try to pin them deep as well. But instead, Coach Jaden, I think we're going to get a timeout for the Tigers to talk things over. On this fourth down play coming up.
I'm looking at Drew Quartz's numbers, Brett. He's 4 of 16 for 53 yards. He's only completed one out of his last seven throws.
Wow.
So it's been tough sledding for him.
Both defenses playing physical, playing tough, right? A lot of mistakes on both sides, playing behind the sticks at times. 21-6 now, Kimberly with the lead. Ricardo, 25 seconds left in the half.
Wow, they responded well. See, they got punched a little bit by East, coming back with some couple touchdowns. I know Rosie's liking the Metallica that's being played right now. Classic Ride the Lightning cut.
Well, here we go, coming off that timeout. Fourth down and 10 for Courts and the Irish. Again, he's got some time, gonna go deep downfield, and just too much.
And it was double covered too, Brett.
It was, but just a little too much mustard on that for Wadeen to go up and get it. So turnover on downs with 2:06 to play. Just one timeout remaining for the Tigers. And Ricardo, with the way the Freedom defense, though, has been playing, bottling up that Tiger rushing attack, a chance still with Irish with three timeouts. Maybe get that ball back yet before the end of the half.
The first play here is critical for Wrightstown. See if they can get positive yards, maybe a big chunk play.
Well, there's Vandehye waiting for the snap, handoff. Nope, Vandehye's got it, and Freedom not fooled in the lead. I was fooled. I was looking at the guy, the toolbox. I thought Helfrey had the ball, pretty good play fake, but instead a one-yard loss on that run by Vandehye.
It's not hard to fool you, my friend.
No
offense.
It isn't. I spend most of my time at these live streams watching the game through binoculars because it's just easier to see the numbers.
Second down and 11 for Wrightstown. Give up the middle.
Oh, boy. Wow, there he goes again, lowering those pads. Boy, he dips that shoulder down, Ricardo. No, there's really nowhere to grab him, number one. And then that center of gravity so low to the ground, you think you got him. He just bounces you off you like a pinball, keeps pushing his way forward. And first down by Helfrey.
I'd give him the ball more. He has three carries for 55 yards unofficially for Helfrey, the toolbox.
This time, Helfrey, the lead blocker for Humphreys. And it looks like the Tigers. Nope, I think they're going to stop the clock for equipment issues. You don't see too many programs, Ricardo, looking at the Tiger sideline with the names on their backs of their jerseys.
Yeah, it's nice. Yeah. You know, you don't, again, it's. Nothing wrong with it. I just think teams have gone away with it for that team first mentality, which I think is a horse apiece in some ways. I think it's I know Springs does that.
Bunton trying to get around that far side. Oh, chase down. Whoa. That was some speed there by, I think that was number three. Was that Matthew Eberhardt again, the senior outside linebacker, just flying? Looked like Button had an ability, maybe a chance to get around that edge, but like a flash, number three in a white jersey chasing him down. So third down. And that's Humphreys, and I would think the Tigers want to burn a timeout. Well, they're going to move the sticks and quickly to the line of scrimmage, trying to conserve that timeout. They'll clock the ball there. Second down coming up at 20.3 seconds to go.
Second and 10 for the Tigers. The Freedom 46-yard line.
So now I have an unofficial total for Humphreys. Four carries, 62 yards, Brett. Second down and 10 from the 46. They're in Freedom territory.
Got a text from our colleague, Mike Sherry, 21-6 Kimberly with the halftime lead. If anybody has a Little Chute Luxembourg Casco score, that's a big one in the Northeastern Conference tonight. Looks like Freedom timeout here. Try to look for it on Twitter. I didn't see it. Anybody knows what's going on? I believe that's being played at in Luxembourg tonight.
Fondi is up 14-10 over Freedom, or I'm sorry, over Cocon at the half.
Okay.
They scored a touchdown off interception. So that's a big one to watch.
Finley Dorio, one of the top passers in our
coverage. I think that's his first
area.
Pick of the year.
Might be the sensational Kakana quarterback. Thought Nina did a pretty good job of kind of bottling up that passing attack, but the Ghosts really ran the ball well against
Nina.
Yeah,
and it was a
week.
Nice varied attack. It wasn't one person.
Yeah.
He had a nice mix of runners.
Speaking of which, the head coach at Kakana used to be the co-head coach, Matt Binsfeld at Kakana, used to be a co-coach with Steve Klister here at Wrightstown.
That's
they
true.
Won a state championship together. Kakana and Wrightstown really just essentially neighboring communities just down the road from each other. Very close drive. Let's take 96 or what's that, County Z? Back into town, back into Kakana from here.
You're asking the wrong guy. I don't know where I'm
going. Why don't you do some exploring sometime?
I don't know where I'm going.
Second down for Vandehei, and he's going to drop back. Fire. Watch out. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. This is going to be a pick six down the near sideline. Whoa, he brought down. I thought for sure that was going to be a pick six. What a tackle by Vandehei, the quarterback, but Noah Heinke with the interception. Credit Vandehei, Ricardo, for coming in. I thought Heinke was gone. Didn't you?
50-yard return, Brett, on that interception. So good job, Vandehei, to track him down.
What we're looking at first, there's nothing but green grass ahead for Heinke. So, yeah, very good hustle by Vandehei to bring down Heinke, but I thought he was gone.
Well, Heinke showing good anticipation, Brett, on that pick.
So now here come the Irish. And it looks like Wrightstown will take its final timeout. But what a critical interception there.
9.1 seconds, is that what it's?
Yeah.
Okay. Nina leading Oshkosh West. Brett, did you hear their theater group is performing Grease?
Yeah.
I love Grease. Beauty school dropout.
You know, who was that? Frankie
Valley?
Who was that?
Avalon? Yeah.
I thought you were going to give me a little John Travolta.
Oh, no. And for karaoke, I do beauty school dropout all the time.
Yeah.
Skipped your midterms and flunk shampoo.
It's a good movie.
I love that movie as a kid. I mean, it's iconic. You're a kid watching that all the time.
How'd you like to be John Travolta in 1978 when you had movies with the top two soundtracks, Grease and Saturday Night Fever?
Boy, was he everywhere, wasn't he?
Oh, boy. And then Welcome Back, Cotter. Now we're really going old school for all the young kids watching. Just Google Welcome Back, Cotter.
What?
Wait. Vinny Barbarino, right? All right, courts now. He's got time. No,
Look out.
He's going to. Whoa, and oh. Heinke
trying
to get into the
oh
end zone.
Goodness.
He got in as the clock expires. 14 yards to Heinke.
Again, Brett off a broken play.
What a play by the Irish to close out the half. Second touchdown pass of the night for Quartz. Wow. And Nolan Phillips with the PAT to close out this first half. And it's good. Ricardo, what an incredible turn of events here for this first. Heinke with the interception there, and then with the touchdown reception.
Yeah, I think what's got to kill Wrightstown is that both of those pass, those touchdowns came on pass plays they could have prevented. They had Quartz down, and Quartz able to escape, make a play with his feet, and get two touchdowns passing. I want to say big old number 75 had him dead to rights, Brett.
Yeah.
Nowitzki.
So a 14-yard hookup. And some fireworks here to close out this first half on homecoming night. Mm. Crazy game, crazy end of the half. And, yeah, as we look at our CellCom Cooney's Embroidery and Sportswear scoreboard on homecoming night here, week five, Freedom now, as we see with that touchdown as time expired to end the first half, Irish leading Wrightstown 14-7. We've got a lot to talk about here, things coming up digitally with USA Today Network Wisconsin. We'll also talk about tonight's game and maybe catch up on some other scores after this short break. Welcome back to Wrightstown High School. Halftime here again, week five homecoming matchup. Quick look at our CellCom Cooney's Embroidery and Sportswear scoreboard shows the Irish leading the Tigers 14-7. Again, thanks to our sponsors, CellCom and Cooney's Embroidery and Sportswear. CellCom's great smartphone event. That's going on right now through October 1st. Get up to $900 when you activate a new line. Savings available on a variety of phones, including top brands. Visit Cellcom.com/save for details. And Cooney's, they have the skills and experience to customize your apparel and spread the word about your organization. Contact them today, 920-731-0922. You can always send them an email at Cooney's, C-O-O-N-E-Y-S, 0922 at sbcglobal.net. Ricardo, before you get to some scores and some thoughts, I also want to tell everybody about our USA Today Sports Plus app. That's the sports app that puts the fans first. Get the latest scores, stats, and standings, and enjoy interactive experiences with our award-winning sports writers. Download USA Today Sports Plus from the Apple or Google Play stores today. USA Today Sports Plus. Fan harder. What do you got, Ricardo?
Well, it's just interesting, real quick, if I can talk about what's transpired so far in the first half. It's interesting that the three touchdowns, Brett, came on a combination of breakdowns by the defense and extraordinary individual efforts on the offensive side of the ball. Right, Wrightstown's lone touchdown came from Humphreys. Right, incredible breaking tackles, many tackles on his way to a 37-yard touchdown run, and then Courts, right, avoiding the pressure, somehow getting a pass off. He got it, I think, to Clawson off a tip pass for the first touchdown.
Yeah.
And then Heinke.
After his interception.
After Heinke got the ball on interception, a 50-yard return, he was able to catch, kind of a scramble drill there as he was trying to avoid that pressure put forward by Nowitzki. Just remarkable athleticism displayed by both sides of the ball, Brett, to get us to this point where we're 14-7. Freedom with the lead.
And what a turn of events, right? Tie game, Wrightstown with the ball. And at the very least, maybe just going to hopefully run the clock out, but to maybe try to set themselves up for a couple more plays before the clock does run out. Instead, Heinke with the 50-yard interception return. I thought he was gone. I the way he was taken off down the near sideline. Really credit Trevor Vandehei, the quarterback, for chasing down Heinke. But Courts and Heinke, and then you mentioned that too. Courts eluding Ricardo pressure on that last throw, but Heinke, he had kind of danced his way into the end zone too and make some guys miss, and he's been doing that all night long. He's really tough to bring down the way he's kind of cuts and zigs and zags his way up and down the field. So a heck of a play on both ends by Courts and Heinke. I got a score here. Folks from the Northeastern Conference will be very interested to know at halftime, Luxembourg Casco leading Little Chute 21-7.
So the Spartans, what was the score?
21-7. Spartans have the Mustangs down at the half. And I know Luxembourg Casco's got a good squad as well, and as we said in the first half. Looking at the Northeastern Conference standings, Luxembourg Casco, Fox Valley Lutheran, and Little Chute both coming into tonight's action with 2-0 records in the league.
Gonna see if I can get some updated scores. We knew the halftime score between Kimberly and Appleton East, 21-6. Kimberly leading Appleton East. And then the big one down in the southeastern part of the state. I think that is of general interest because it might be the game of the week, in the state, Brett, when it's Muskego and Mukwonago playing.
Yeah.
17-7, Muskego leading Mukwonago at the half. Other scores, Wautoma 27, Clintonville nothing at the half. And Hustacon 29-14 over Clinton. I'm sorry, I thought that was Chilton. So I don't know if people really care too much about that score. But I will say again, Brett, I think you mentioned this. Nina 35-7 over Oshkosh West. Good bounce back game for the Rockets, Brett.
Yeah, and Oshkosh West kind of one of those tricky teams. They've been playing some pretty good games, some good football.
This is an interesting game, only because this is on the eastern part of the state. Two Rivers is leading Keele only 20-13. Two Rivers in the top eight of the rankings, and traditionally a very strong team. That's interesting to watch.
Keele always has good athletes and athletics as well. That's a fun town to go to, and kids growing up had some activities at Keele. Always enjoy going there.
Where's Keel?
If you
give
go
me a general,
like by Chilton area.
Ah, okay.
Go past
okay.
Chilton down. Yes. Is that Highway 57?
Oh, and I don't know where the wagon is.
Yeah, we lost our wagon. Our wagon is gone. It must be under the bleachers somewhere. If not, we're going to be taking lots of trips to your car.
Yes.
So Ricardo, while you're looking up some scores, just want to remind everybody our Clubhouse Live show is underway. We've got two shows under our belt. That's our weekly Packers show. takes place every Monday at 6:30 from the Fox Club at Neuroscience Group Field at Fox City Stadium in Grand Chute, home of the Wisconsin Timber Rattlers. That's our new home, and so thrilled to have our show there. We've had two great crowds to start. 2 weeks ago, we had John Kuhn on, the former Packers Pro Bowl fullback, All-Pro. And last week, this past Monday, Keyshawn Nixon and Josiah DeGuara. Of course, Keyshawn Nixon, the All-Pro return man, and did a nice job playing slot corner again that week one win against the Bears. And Josiah, a tight end slash fullback, I guess. He said he's all of the above, but they're going to be our season co-hosts. So they came on together this past week. We celebrated the big Packers victory over the Bears, and Keyshawn now will be on this coming Monday, and he'll bring a teammate guest. Still waiting to hear who that will be. I'll announce it on our Facebook page, facebook.com/clubhouselive, but you can definitely check out the show in person. We'd love to have you in person. Doors open at 4. Admission is free. First come, first seated. But again, there's plenty of space, free parking at the stadium. And Neuroscience Group Field is right off of I-41, so very easy to get to from, say, Wrightstown. Just hop on 41 and you're there in 15 minutes or so, 20 minutes tops. Yeah, so really looking forward to that. We'll talk about the big Packers-Falcons game. I co-hosted Ricardo, the Bears fan. He's a co-host as well. Rosie's part of the production crew. If you can't make it in person, we stream it live on all our websites. We think Facebook. You know, Facebook's been not working for Vimeo for the past couple days now.
Much to the chagrin of Mr. Jim Rosendale.
Yeah. Again, not of our doing. Nothing we can do about it. And but they assure us they're working on it, trying to get the fixes made. But also our USA Today Network Wisconsin YouTube channel. So, again, multiple ways, multiple platforms to watch. Definitely check that out. And, again, give us a like, facebook.com/clubhouselive, facebook.com/packersnews as well.
Menasha up over Green Bay East 35-0. That's not really a surprise. Appleton North up 21-0 over Oshkosh North. That's not really a surprise either. Fond du Lac 14-10. Over Kaukauna. That's a big one being played down in Fond du Lac, Brett. I mean, again, Fond du Lac, they're in a corner right now. They're a dangerous beast. My boss, Mike Sherry, he saw Fond du Lac last week, and he thought they should have beaten Kimberly. He says that team is loaded with talent, maybe a bit young, so they don't quite know how to win yet, but that's going to be a powerhouse, maybe even by early next year.
Well, if they lose tonight by 0-5, getting pretty tough to...
Yeah, they'd have to win out, essentially, and hope for, and have your fingers crossed that, you know, you'll get in. Teams have gotten in with the losing record before, though, Brett.
And we thought, Fondy, when we streamed that game week three, was that 2 weeks ago at Fond du Lac, I think we were there?
3 weeks ago.
3 weeks ago? No.
Yeah.
This is week five.
Was it week three? I thought it was week two.
Yeah, week two we did Menasha.
Oh, yeah, you're right. Okay.
So a couple weeks ago, you know, North had Fond du Lac down with 21-6, and next thing you know, it's a 21-19 game with Fond du Lac with the ball, trying to get into field goal range before Brock Arndt made a big defensive play, one of the stalwart defensive guys on that Appleton North defense. And so the comeback bid by Fond du Lac was just a little short. But, yeah, they look good. Connor Klaprick, the quarterback, looks good. And that was it Max Mengel, the tight end, who really stood out to us as an athlete and a big target for Klaprick. But we'll see. Like we kind of talked about with Appleton East, you got to get that signature win under your belt, right? You got to be able to pull one of these games out. You can't keep losing these close games. And now Appleton East definitely struggling to keep pace with Kimberly tonight. Ricardo, I know you probably want to talk about Varsity Roundtable, but also the launching of the
920
branded,
Sports.
Yeah.
Rebrand.
There you go.
Of 920 Sports. Go on. If you go on to Google Play, Stitcher, or iTunes, you should find the formerly, it was the podcast formerly known as the R&B Show. It's now 920 Podcast. A little bit of a rebranding, just kind of more to fit geographically kind of what we're all about high school sports in the Fox Valley area. We do add a little bit of pro stuff too as well, because that's obviously of high interest around here as well. So we talked at length about some of the top teams, football teams in the Valley. I know we talked about Wrightstown and Freedom. And we also talked about the great volleyball that we have going on both on the girls and the boys' side. Brett gave us an update on that award show, which is – I know it's far away seemingly in May, but it's really not that far away when you think about it. Brett is going to be here before you know it. And, we also talked about some of that pro stuff with the Packers, Brewers, a little bit of Badgers. So please check us out. It's the only podcast primarily dedicated to high school sports in the Fox Valley area. And we're planning on it being biweekly. Now, that can change depending on availability of coaches. If we can get a coach in or something like that in between those weeks, we're going to do one.
Do it on the phone.
We could do it on the phone as well. So I already got some feelers out, Brett, to coaches who could join us. Maybe for a little bit of a short interview on the sports. Because a lot of times we tape that when the coaches, who are primarily teachers, are in the classroom or maybe they're at lunch or something like that. Just got to work out the coordination there in terms of time-wise. But we should be able to bring that added context to all of our podcasts.
Yeah, looking forward to it. The 920 Sports Podcast. And then gives it a name that people know what's going on.
Yeah. And then we have the Varsity Roundtable every Wednesday, 7 o'clock. It's the only online high school sports talk to no state. This past Wednesday, just a few days ago, we had Xavier Girls Volleyball. They brought in their Division II state championship trophy, Brett. And we talked to them at length about the great season they've been having. They were 21-1 going into this weekend, the number one ranked team in Division II. And are they the best team in Appleton? Well, we're going to find out, because next Friday, Brett, they're playing Appleton North in pool play down at the West Bend.
Say that time, yeah. Are you going to be there?
Oh, I think me and Mike Sherry have worked out. Perhaps Mike will be joining you guys, and I'll head down there. That's a big game. Like, those two teams don't cross paths all the time, because one's Division One, one's Division Two. But that looks to be a good one. So I'm really curious to see. Brett, there's a lot of Division One collegiate players on that court when those two teams play.
That's a big time game. Too bad it can't be in Appleton.
And I should ask Coach Sherrill or Appleton, how come you don't schedule like a non-conference duel or something?
How about this? Why not a big tournament or invite like that in the Fox Valley?
We do have one. It's called Beast of the Northeast. The only problem with that's put together by a friend, Chris Fitzgerald from Prep Dick. Mm. The problem with that, the Beast of the Northeast happens to be the same weekend as the Joust.
So they gotta rework that.
Yeah,
then.
Exactly. So. And most of the top teams have already committed to the Joust, Brad, because that is the premier tournament in the state of Wisconsin that early on in the season.
Yeah, then they got to figure out a way to spread that out a little bit, because I think that'd be good. I thought there used to be a volleyball early season between like FBA schools and Northeastern Conference schools were part of that.
Oh yeah, it used to be the Battle of the Valley.
Yeah, right.
They don't have that anymore that I know of.
Maybe the Post Crescent should put it together, or USA Today Network Wisconsin sponsor that.
That's not out of the realm of possibilities. So
where would you play that? At the Champion Center, maybe? Or
that's a good point. Brett, these are all very good ideas, actually.
Thank you.
That you have. Maybe that's something we consider live streaming, Rosie, whenever you get your cart back.
Yeah. Our wagon is somewhere
wagon.
In Wrightstown right now.
Our wagon.
Somebody might be wheeling that downtown, for
Brett,
all we know.
Did you mention the Packer show?
Yeah, I did. I talked about the Packer. Glad you were listening.
Well, I was doing updating scores and things like that. I will say this, Brett. One other feature that we're doing with the Clubhouse Live is we're honoring local high schools, high school teams. We've done primarily football the first 2 weeks. Well, we've done both football the first 2 weeks with Menasha and then Appleton North to start. And I think we're going to be honoring some of our volleyball teams in the next coming week. So it's another way to kind of just showcase the – absurd amount of good teams that we have in our area, the successful championship quality type of teams. So again, that's something to look forward to every Monday during that Clubhouse Live show.
Yeah, and we got the space to do it now.
We do.
Something we talked about even when we were at the old place, but just didn't have the seats. But now we do, and it's I think a nice feature. And
it's something that we can transition. And I know this is your thing. We can transition into basketball.
Oh yeah,
the season unfolds.
We'll no doubt do
right,
that.
Right. So maybe a little Wrightstown wrestling coming in as well. So,
yeah, absolutely.
We'll see if we can figure something out, because we love showcasing the athletes. That's the heart and soul of this Fox Valley is high school sports.
Second to none, right? As far as talent goes.
I agree.
And then next Friday we'll be. Yeah. So you mentioned me, Rosie, Mike, Sherry. We're going to be somewhere. That's to be determined.
Yes. Right? You're
looking at some matchups and.
Yeah, and that's always something interesting to see how you kind of put that together, Brett. Because there's a lot of potential games. Well, maybe not a lot, but there's a few potential games that we could be at, you guys could be at.
A lot of the schedule is made earlier, because press box space is at a premium. So I want to make sure we get some of these top games. And also, too, we try to showcase as many teams and leagues as we can. We've showcased the FEA, we've showcased the FRCC North and South, and now we're showcasing the Northeastern Conference. Would love to get a Xavier on there, but the Bay is just generally...
It's not a good league other than Xavier.
Right, so it's going to be tough to kind of maybe get them in the playoffs potentially, maybe play in Wrightstown again or a Freedom again or a Little Shoot. You know, we'll see how it all plays out.
Again, that's a Division IV team. Yeah. Think how many great Division IV teams we have in this area.
Our state power, that can make runs, deep runs, and be knocking at the door to get to Madison. So, yeah, you look at our core leagues, the FEA, the NEC, the FRCC, probably the top three, right, I would say, as leagues. You know, the two of them are D1, D2, and this is a D4-ish. I guess, is Luxembourg Casco D4 or they D3?
I know FEL is D3. A lot of times you'll see they're right on that cusp, right?
So, yeah, so you try to kind of make that schedule, and then you get to, like, crunch time or the stretch run, then you really start focusing. And I leave a few weeks open. Give me some wiggle room to see who's doing what, right? Maybe potential conference championships on the line. I can tell you that week 7 we'll have Nina Kimberly at Kimberly, and week 9 we'll have Kimberly Appleton North at Appleton North. And the way it's kind of looking right now, that Kimberly Appleton North team game
could be for the FEA title.
It could be both undefeated.
Yep.
You know, of course, Nina might have something to say about that because the Rockets take on Appleton North next week at Kaukauna. Nina.
And Kaukauna.
And Kaukauna, too. Third quarter about to get underway. Scoring all in the second quarter, guys, right? 5-yard touchdown pass, or 25-yard touchdown pass. This is Freedom from Drew Quartz to Carson Clausen with the 10:31 mark, made it 7-0. Wrightstown answered that 37-yard touchdown run by Landon Helfrey with 5:15 in place, made it 7-all. And as time expired, Quartz again, a 14-yard hookup to number 18, Noah Heinke. And that's where we're at. That's kind of an off-schedule play, without a doubt. Quartz scrambling under heavy pressure, was able to unload it to Heinke. Heinke dancing his way into the end zone. He had the 50-yard interception return to set up the score. And as we look at our Cellcom Cooney's Embroidery and Sportswear scoreboard, 14-7, Freedom with the lead.
28-0 lead now for Appleton North over Oshkosh North, Brett. Looking at some more scores from our area.
Well, you do that. I'm going to be looking at seeing how the Brew Crew's doing tonight, and they're down 3-0. Ooh. To the Nationals?
The Nationals?
A team that's got, what, 80-plus losses? Come on now.
That's with the ghost of Strasburg as well.
Mm. Can't be doing that.
How many games are they above the Cubs?
4.5, I believe.
Okay, well, they push that out a little bit.
They do, but you got to take care of teams like the Nationals at home, right? I guess the key now, if you just win series, you'll skate into the playoffs, but you don't want that last series against the Cubs, the season-ending series, to mean anything. You want to have that division wrapped up. Second half underway, Freedom kicking it off, and oh, wow, big hit. I think that, who's that, number 20, is that Jaden Kiddo with the return? And we are underway. So, Ricardo, if you're both sides, right, Steve Clister and Charlie Jaden, I guess your message is because it was a goofy second quarter in particular. A little sloppy both sides.
Just do what we do, right? For Wrightstown, it's just been a couple breakdowns on defense and a very good scrambling quarterback that's kind of led to their two touchdowns. I mean, there's no need to change the game plan. They're only down by a score, Brett. So I think it would be nice if you could start fast with this drive to open the second half.
And no pre-snap penalties, right?
Yeah, that too.
Definitely got to clean that up as Vandehei now. Just nowhere to go. Boy, that Freedom defense really flying to the football, making it very tough for that rushing attack to really get any footing right now.
5-yard carry there for Vandehei. He has 6 carries for 16 yards in the game. Second down and 5 from the 36 for Wrightstown. Vandehei gives up the middle.
Mm. again, wrapped up. There's a little bit of a push. That was Daniel Bunton, number four. But then it just, the holes plug up. And
there by Bunton.
Nowhere for Bunton to go. Looked like he kind of lowered those pads and was had a maybe a chance to kind of get through that mess, but he stood up and pushed back. So third and what, four maybe coming up for the Tigers here. Big play right here to start the second half.
I'd give it to Humphrey.
Vandehei looking downfield and
play complete.
He did. And that's to Caldwell. Good concentration for Caldwell to come down with it. That was a little bit low, but
yeah, they needed four, but got six.
Yeah, it does the job, right? Moves the chains and keeps this drive going.
Yeah, he had actually Humphreys was out there blocking for him, so a little rollout, get some guys in front of you to make sure you don't have anyone pressuring you.
Some big boys on that offensive line. Looking at number 67 in particular, we talked about it, Charles Garvey, 340-pound senior offensive lineman, 6'4". Now what do we have? Another procedure call, yeah. Ricardo.
I tell you what, that Garvey, Brett, he was on the short list to be on my Elite 11.
Were you close?
Yeah, he was right there.
First teamer, again, the only first team offensive lineman returning in the NEC this year. Big, strong kid.
He was definitely on my top players to watch overall, top 25 area football players.
Vandehei kind of try to run that
Clausen.
Way. Yeah, boy, just filling the holes. And you can see Clausen celebrating that tackle.
Same thing for Carson Clausen, Brett. Another two-way, great two-way player.
He was close
to. Just missed out the Elite 11, yeah. I remember talking over that team with Mike Sherry. And I think we went with the tight end from Nina.
Luke Keller.
Yes. He was rated a little higher on the overall rankings of senior tight ends.
Ricardo, he knows you're here, and he's also threw a point. Huh?
Yes.
And a high again. Looking for some blocking.
He's got some.
He got cut it through and dives for close to the first down, maybe a couple yards shy, but a good run getting out in space on that far left side. Good blocking.
Well,
and right at midfield.
Brad, he was patient, right? He waited for his blocks to develop. And now it's a very manageable third and three.
Yeah, you think maybe the toolbox could get a touch?
Oh, yeah.
That would be number 30.
Landon Helfrey.
Yep, the fullback. And could be his time here on a big third down play again as Wrightstown running to the line of scrimmage.
I see him right there in the fullback position.
Yeah, let's see if he gets the carry. Nope. Vandehei is going to try to use his lead blockers and trying to cut it in. Just gets the first down. That'll move the chains. Probably got a couple yards more than he needed. Ball in Freedom territory at the 45. Got just kind of some sweeps on each side, Ricardo.
What was the old Lombardi line? You got a seal here and a seal here, and you run it up the alley. Am I right?
You're right. And those old Lombardi stories where they say they'd run that sweep like time and time again, just repeatedly, because teams couldn't stop it. It was so well executed.
It's a nice drive so far by Wrightstown, Brett. Six-play drive. Started at its own 31. Now they're past midfield at the 45 of Freedom. Key conversion pass on third down to keep this one going.
Vandehei going to keep it himself again, and boy.
He's doing a good job, Brett. Some of those snaps have been not perfect, let's say.
Henry Vandehei, the junior tackle, 6'5", or defensive tackle, 230 pounds. Getting in on that tackle, and then he helps Vandehei back up.
36 yards on 10 carries for Vandehei.
Second down for Vandehei. Been kind of doing all the work himself. There's number 35 now diving forward, Aiden Humphreys. And Third down coming up. Ricardo, obviously four down territory here with about 4 yards to pick up. Wrightstown doing what it needs to do, kind of keep moving the chains, right, controlling the ball and keeping that Freedom offense off the field. You look at the clock.
Yeah, more than 5 minutes have expired here so far on this drive.
Yeah, clock continuing to run, 6.5 to play, so controlling, possessing the ball for halfway through this first stretch of the third quarter. Banda high again, high snap. He's going to drop back the pass. Watch out.
Got him open.
And a nice deliver.
That was a
fastball, Ricardo.
Kiddo, hey, that was a nice route. You know, timing thing and a nice pass from Banda High. And
yeah, his most confident throw, right, to plant it on that back foot, step through with that lead foot, and really just delivered a fastball to Kiddo. So it was a nice pass along that near sideline. No surprise, though, right? He's ranked as a top high school baseball player. Talking about Trevor Banda High, top high school baseball player in the state in the class of 2025 by Prep Baseball Report Wisconsin.
11-yard connection there. He takes himself off the right side. Ooh.
Showing off his athleticism and his moves, and the Tigers on the run.
He's close to another first down.
Yeah,
it is.
Banda High, Ricardo, he hit 378 this past spring for the Tigers. Had a home run, 10 RBI, also finished with 37 total bases, 43 on base percentage. Only the second year he's played quarterback. Brother Trent is a guard for Wrightstown. But I was looking at the PBR Wisconsin website and what they had to say about him. Quote, there are a few prospects in the region who boast the advanced tool set Banda High currently possesses.
Okay.
So top junior baseball player in the state of Wisconsin by PBR Wisconsin. And also looking up a couple of his stats. See, they had his exit velocity at a high of 103.1 miles per hour at one point. He's an outfielder, and he's been clocked at throwing as high as 91. So you got a big arm, great bat. And Ricardo, somebody that you're going to have to keep an eye on come the baseball season.
Absolutely. Tonight he has 12 carries for 48 yards and doing a nice job on this drive. Again, that started way back at the 31.
Number 72, Sam Coyler, offensive lineman, 6'3", 230-pound senior, hobbling off. Ooh.
Not happy. Ball's just outside the 15, Brett. 12th play of this drive.
Trying to walk that off, but showing some frustration as he tossed the helmet down on the trainer's table now. They're going to take a look. In the meantime, play continues. I think that's Aiden Humphreys with the carry. And Ricardo, look at that. We're down to 5 minutes still remaining, and it's been 7 minutes to open this half. Wrightstown still with the football. And third down coming up.
Third and five for the Tigers.
I mean, this is Wrightstown football right here, Brett.
Yeah, ball at the 12.
Ball control, letting those big dudes up there eat. And really kind of punish that defensive line. Banda High.
Humphreys powering his way. It's going to be close. It'll be fourth down coming up. He'll be about a yard shy, maybe.
I think that's right.
Yard or two, maybe 2 yards shy.
Yeah, it's at the nine, so let's call it a short two.
So fourth down, and Coach Clister, you know they're going to go for it. They're not going to settle for field goals here.
You know who I want to give it to.
Yeah, the toolbox. You want Landon Helfrey?
Give it to Helfrey. Again, 5'9", 190-pound fullback, but he plays a lot bigger than that. Under 4 minutes left in the third quarter, Brett. This is taking up the entire quarter, this drive.
Yeah. Well, let's see. Banda High is under center. Helfrey next to him. Banda High is just going to sneak forward. Lil, I don't know.
I don't know either.
I don't know.
I think it's at the eight.
Yeah, Freedom celebrating. I think they got the stop. The Irish get the stop. It's going to be a turnover on downs, presumably. They're celebrating. The officials, though, talking things over. And they're going to give it to Freedom. So Freedom holds. Went with the quarterback sneak just a little short. And, boy, you get all that way and coming up with nothing, that's tough.
14-play drive, Brett.
Mm.
14 plays.
Ate up over 8 minutes.
Yeah, 60 yards on that drive. And to come away with no points, disappointing for the Wrightstown coaching staff, I'm sure. They felt good about that play call, just fell a yard short.
Well, here comes Drew Courts. First time we get to see him this second half. Oh, boy. Good. good awareness because that was a crazy snap. But look, he looks like
scrambling around.
I was going to say Fran Tarkin, but that's way too old.
Yeah,
of
people
don't
know who that
can
is.
I say
Fred.
Steve Young, maybe?
That's a little too big. Maybe Lamar Jackson.
There you go. I'm trying to think of a scrambling quarterback nowadays.
Johnny Manziel?
Does he even play anymore?
No. But that was his game, scrambling all around. Right, this is imperative for Wrightstown defense to kind of force a three and out. You'll be able to get the ball back with pretty good field position if you're able to hold Freedom here.
Guess who? Heinke. Look at him dance through. Look at him dance through. Turns on the Jets, still finally out of bounds at the 50. Wow. They're going to say he stepped out at the 46-yard line, but Ricardo, the way he moves, he just kind of slithers through all that traffic.
Yeah, made a nice little move right when he cut, you know, planted that foot, made a nice little cut, and able to get it near midfield. 33-yard gain.
35-6 now, Kimberly leading Appleton East. Carson Pendleton, 3 touchdown passes, so Papermakers well on their way to 4-0. Remember, they had the week one game scrap. Milwaukee Marshall was the opponent, but not enough numbers for Marshall, so Kimberly a game behind, I guess you could say, the rest of the state. And look at that, Humphrey. Wow! Humphrey coming in big time. Humphreys, I should say, bringing down Jack Bonnet. And a junior linebacker. And a flag down.
Was that a pass play, Brett, out there?
No, that was a run.
Okay.
And what are they going to call here?
They're saying it's against Freedom.
A hold against Freedom. I think there was a thought maybe a horse collar tackle, but it looked like a pretty clean tackle to me.
I think they're going to make them take. They're going to take that penalty, yeah, though. It would be second and 12 if they didn't.
I think you push them back, make it far behind the sticks as possible, right? And look at where the Freedom huddle's getting ready to gather. It's going to be at the 36-yard line.
First and 20 for the Irish.
Yeah, first and 20 is exactly right. So see if Drew Quartz, if he can get back into this. Good old slugfest here in the Northeastern Conference between these two longtime rivals. There's Quartz again on the run. Good play fake. You're going to kind of flick it and, oh,
off his hands, off his helmet.
Bonnet, the intended receiver, but again, good coverage. Daniel Bunton this time. But how about that little flick from Quartz? Tough going on the run to his left as a right-handed quarterback, but darn near completed that.
Tigers defense has the advantage here, Brett, at second and 20. Now, you know, the nice run by Heinke got him out to the 46, but here, if you can hold them, then enforce a punt, that's a win.
Quartz waiting for his guys to get all set, waiting for that snap, got it. And that's a handoff to number 4. That's Aaron Hamble, the junior, but how about number 78, Brendan Gustafson, the 6'3", 250-pound defensive lineman getting in there. And
third and 18
will be what awaits Quartz next. If you're here, you got to be careful if you're Freedom. Whoa, watch out. Fumble. Oh, I think the Tigers got it. The Tigers picked it up.
Brad, who picked that up?
That's number 69, Trent Vandehei. I believe that's the brother of Trevor Vandehei. Senior defensive end coming in. Bad snap. Or I don't know if it was just too fast of a snap. It bounced off of Quartz's hands too high, too fast. Skips to the turf and Trent Vandehei picks it up, and a big turnover. Wrightstown now with the ball inside the 35 at the Freedom 34.
Wrightstown has to punch this in for points, Brett. They got down to the 8-yard line where that turnover on downs. Get second life here.
Well, Vander High is going to keep it himself. Trevor Vander High sells the play fake, but keeps it, dives forward for about two
Trevor
or three Vander yards.
Nixon,
Freedom not fooled by much with this
no.
running game tonight, are they?
Been
a staple for Steve Clister forever here. And what a career Coach Clister has had at Wrightstown. Three state championships. Closing in on 200 career victories as well, Ricardo.
Heck of a career, no doubt about it.
Vander High is going to hand off to Humphreys. Ooh, breaks a tackle, but not much there. Yeah, Steve Clister, longtime head coach, has led the Tigers to three titles. Division 5 back in 98 and Division 4 titles in 06 and 11. Remember, he co-coached the team with Bill Aynard as part of those 98 and 06 title teams. And then, as I mentioned earlier, he was a co-coach with Matt Binsfeld for that 11 championship team. Matt Binsfeld, now the head coach with the Ghosts. But
wow, it's been 12 years already?
2011, yeah.
Oh, man. I was there for that one.
Steve Clister, 5 victories away from 200 for his career. He's a member of the Wisconsin Football Coaches Association Hall of Fame. Trevor Vander High, wow.
Oh, 79.
Yeah.
Wyatt Tolliver?
Yeah, Wyatt Tolliver, a 5'8". He looks bigger than that, doesn't he? A 180-pound senior defensive end, really laying a pretty good shot on Trevor Vander High. Vander High, that's going to be the final play of the third quarter, so some time for Coach Clister and that staff to come up with a good fourth down play.
The end of the third quarter, your score.
Now that we're making the transition to the final 12 minutes of this slugfest here in week 5. Look at our Cellcom, Cooney's Embroidery and Sportswear scoreboard. Freedom with the lead, 14-7. Well, kind of following that path, Ricardo. Quarters 1 and 3 scoreless. Quarter 2 was kind of crazy. Maybe quarter 4 will be a little crazy. Again, don't forget Bill Glasheen down there going back and forth with all the media guys here. A lot of media here tonight, Ricardo, I've noticed. A lot of cameras. Big game.
It is.
One of the big games here in Northeast Wisconsin, the Fox Valley region. But Bill, there's Bill. You're getting his good side, Rosie. He's
yeah,
the guy
he's
on the left.
Clean shaven tonight.
I noticed that. I didn't recognize him. Haircut, clean shaven. He looks about 10 years younger now. But check out his great work. He and Dan Powers, two of the best, without a doubt. You see it on postcrescent.com, greenbaypressgazette.com after the game tonight. And you can always check our live streams, by the way. We've got those easily accessible. Just look them up, previous Game of the Week live streams on any of our sites. Just go to the sports section and scroll down until you see the Watch Our Varsity Game of the Week. Prep live streams link. Ricardo, fourth down. Vander High,
oh, wide, open.
Wide open, and almost breaks free for the score. But how about a quick pass to Kiddo? Nice job by Drew Kortz to bring down Kiddo. Otherwise, he's celebrating a touchdown right now. So maybe that's the game plan. Maybe the game plan has to shift a little bit to kind of loosen up that Freedom defense. Maybe Vander High in that passing offense is going to have to do a few more things, have a few more instances like that where you're striking through the air.
Yeah, 15-yard pass. Gets it down to the 15-yard line. Brett, you know, Wrightstown's in a good position here. They got to come in with points. Touchdown, preferably.
Vander High is going to keep it, trying to get around, and oof. 26 for the Irish. Nixon Heinke, linebacker. Carl, these kids are going to be sore after this one.
Yes.
This has been some serious hits going on both sides. Still think... I know it's not the strength of your offense, but he's completing some passes. He's a little bit of a rhythm in the passing game. I think he got something there.
I want to see Landon Helfrey. Am I wrong?
He's out there
carrying the ball a little bit.
He's out there at that fullback spot. Let's see if he was going to be the lead blocker for Vander High. Yep, Vander High is going to keep it again, and Vander High inside the 5.
More importantly, I think that's a first down
it
and goal
is.
To goal.
Yep, chains are down. So exactly right. So Wrightstown trying to turn a turnover into some points. Ball will be marked at the 4-yard line.
62 yards on, I have 16 carries for Vandehei. Nice game from him on the ground. Also, again, had that key 15-yard reception on 4th and 6, Brett, that extended this drive.
Vandehei under center, waiting for the snap. Hand off to, oh, almost in. I think he was stood up right at the goal line. That's number 28, Caden Caldwell.
It's right at the 1.
And I think in this case, yeah, ball will be marked right at the 1. Let's see if it's inside the 1. They're going to spot it right at the 1, but you have, if you're Wrightstown, you have 3 cracks to get this one in from 3 feet out.
And oh, you're thinking it's 4-down territory?
Oh, yeah, I think so.
And good guess.
And I'm thinking you're going to see Vandehei under center, and they're just going to try to sneak this thing in. Vandehei, nope, hand off. And that is he in? He's in. That's a touchdown for number 35, Aiden Humphreys, a 1-yard touchdown plunge into the end zone. And we're a PAT away from a tie ball game. We got a good one here at Wrightstown.
Yeah, good job by the Wrightstown Tigers offense. Not getting down after turning the ball over on downs from their previous drive, Brett. Able to take that interception, or I'm sorry, that fumble recovery, and yep, turn that into a touchdown.
So big PAT here for Daniel Button. See if he can sneak this one through the uprights. And oh, we got a flag. Now what? I think that's going to be on Freedom. It might be an offsides.
I take the point.
Yeah, I would too.
Well, they're coming over to the Wrightstown side.
Say, yeah. What do you want to do?
I think you take the point. It's a tie game at this point.
Yeah, I think that, well, no, they're going to bring the offense on the field.
Okay.
So they are going to go for 2.
All right. Well, I'm a little conservative, I guess.
So, yeah, penalty on the Irish, and here we go. So where does this really officially spot, Ricardo, like the 1.5-yard line?
I would say so. It's half the distance, right? It's
yep,
at the 3, so. So is it a timeout for Wrightstown?
Yeah,
Wrightstown,
I think that's a good idea just to talk this one through.
See, now listen, I'm not traditionally conservative when it comes to the football stuff, but Brett, I think you already have the point on the board. It's a tie game.
I think they're thinking that Coach Klister's thinking yards and points have been very, very hard to come by. You're 1.5 yards from
I don't know. They've played very well in the second half. They've moved the ball in the second half.
Here's the thing. Now maybe you give it to the toolbox, right? Because pretty tough to bring that guy down from 1.5 yards out. But penalty on Freedom on the PAT. Button was able to sail it through.
Well, if you give it to the toolbox, then you sold me, Brett.
He's out there, of course. Humphreys as well. A couple powerful running backs. So the penalty moves at half the distance, and Coach Klister saying, you know what, let's get the offense out on the field. Let's go for the two-point conversion. Now you got Humphreys and Helfrey. Whoa, watch out, and he's trying to squeeze his way in, dives in. Wow, extra effort. Extra effort is able to get it in. That's Caden Caldwell with the two-point conversion run. I thought maybe he was stopped just shy of the goal line, but that extra push at the end, he dives across the goal line.
Showing good balance there because he was struck at about the 1, Brett, able to bounce that off and extend right into the end zone. This is huge for Wrightstown. So instead of being tied, now you're ahead, 15-14, 9:31 left in the fourth.
And as you can tell, by the way, our clock camera is jiggling. Folks here in front of us, the Wrightstown fans, a little excited. Boy, good ball game here tonight. Always is, right? When it doesn't matter if it's a combination of these two teams we've had some good battles between Little Chute and Wrightstown, Little Chute and Freedom. It's just that those three teams in this pocket in the NEC, very, very traditional powers, teams that have all made deep runs to the state playoffs. And you just never know what you're going to get when you kind of blend those three teams together. Tonight we got Freedom and Wrightstown. Again, a series that dates back to 1949, so longtime rivals and living up to kind of what we thought we were going to get. Nice close battle here in week five and a key one at that. Freedom trying to avoid falling to 0-3 in the league. Wrightstown trying to keep pace for a conference title. And that's number 25, Cooper Cappert, senior for the Irish. And this is where Drew Courts and that potentially explosive offense is going to set up.
Cappert on the return.
Ball will be at the 34-yard line.
Tynes, from Cowell.
Last check, Luxembourg Casco was leading Little Chute 21-7. That was a halftime score. Another big game in the NEC. Spartans trying to.
Always a good team up in the.
Yeah. Well, both teams 2-0 coming in. So Spartans eyeing a 3-0 start in the league. Ooh, big time hitting going on now down there. As Heinke with the carry. Heinke's had a nice night for the Irish.
Humphreys and Thompson in on the play. Second and seven.
Courts now got some time and finds Bonnet for the first down in Wrightstown territory.
Courts has passed complete to Bonnet. First down for Freedom, ball in the Wrightstown 49-yard line.
13-yard gain there, Brett. Now they're inside Wrightstown territory. By the way, talking about Noah Heinke, Brett, he has 78 yards on 13 carries. Nice night for him.
Yeah, and the 50-yard interception return
as
well.
That's true.
Courts going to hand it to Heinke, trying to dance his way. Ooh. Nope, nothing doing it. Humphrey's one of those guys there. Bunton as well. And a loss of a couple on that run. Now back in Freedom territory at the 49. I think maybe, yep, 49-yard line. Clock continuing to run, nearing that 8-minute mark. Courts gonna hand off. Ooh, whoa. Look at big 69, Vandehei. Trent Vandehei wrapping up.
Heinke
falling as Vandehei with the tackle. Ball at midfield. Ricardo, huge play in the game right here. Third and 11 for the Irish.
Yeah, and they've been able to, at times, pass the ball well, though a lot of that has been off of Quartz's scrambling ability, Brett. Third and 11. Big play here for the Tigers defense. And what is this? Timeout for Wrightstown?
Yeah.
Timeout, Wrightstown. We have a little time here. Let's.
So one timeout remaining for the Tigers. Again, not sure what we'll be next week. If you're on Twitter, give me a follow, or X. I don't know what to call it anymore. I think everybody still calls it Twitter. I'm at PC Bretzi. I'll make the announcement at some point next week. I can tell you our live coverage will kick off at 6:45 p.m. And again, you can access our previous Game of the Week live streams on our USA Today Network Wisconsin websites. Just go to the sports section, scroll down until you see the Watch Our Varsity Game of the Week Prep live streams link. Also want to plug our digital subscription deal, 6 months for $1, unlimited digital access to the Postcrest, the Press Gazette, any of our USA Today Network Wisconsin websites. Just go to postcrescent.com/subscribe, PressGazette.com, GreenBayPressGazette.com/subscribe to get in on that deal. Ricardo also mentioned our high school sports award show. Yeah, that's going to be May or June, sometime next spring. We're not sure if it's going to be at the Lambeau Field Atrium or the Fox Cities Performing Arts Center, but planning is underway for that, a live in-person show. So we'll provide updates as we get them. Here we go. Hand up. Nope. Course is going to keep it, looking for some space, trying to wiggle his way free, spins his way, and a good run by Course. Ricardo makes fourth down much more manageable now.
If they decide to go for it, it's an 8-yard run.
I think they will.
Lost fourth and four.
With 7 minutes to go, and the fact that, as you said, Wrightstown's been able to kind of get that ground game going, be real methodical. They could run the clock out.
Yes, fourth and three.
So here
a long three.
Here you go. Freedom, a big, big moment in this game. Can the Irish keep this drive going as Quartz waiting for it? High snap. Nope. Play fake. And knocked it. Oh!
Hey, toolbox.
Did he knock it down?
He did.
That's number 30, Landon Hump, Helfrey. We saw what he could do as a fullback. Now we see him as a senior linebacker knocking down that first down throw. It was there, but he got his big old paws in front of it. Now the Tigers in command with the lead and the ball, 6:45 to play. Wow.
Wow, they call him Toolbox, but he can do a whole lot of things, right?
Remember Ed West, the old Green Bay Packers tight end, he was Toolbox.
That's true.
Toolbox, number 86. Rose, you remember Ed West, right? Oh, sure. Now we have a new quarterback in. As Caldwell with the handoff, but Quade Thompson, the senior, now taking some snaps under center. Ricardo, number 5.
Yeah, I'm looking to see if there's an injury or maybe it's just something just to spell.
A little change up. Vandehei's right in front of us on the sideline. Helmet off. Doesn't look like anything's wrong.
And our 50-50 winner tonight is Angie Van Zeelen, has chosen to donate it all back to the Grimm family. Thank you very much.
So Quade Thompson now, the quarterback. Nice to have a senior come in, Ricardo, in this role. See if he can kind of milk this clock out. Hand off. Nope, there's the toolbox right there. Boy, hard, strong run. Landon Helfrey, and that's going to be close to a first down. I think he got the first down. That's imperative for this Freedom defense now to really tighten up, get off the field, and get Quartz back on. Starting to wonder, right, Ricardo, they can start getting worn down a little bit. They were on the field so long in the third quarter.
That's his first carry in the second half.
Mm.
5 carries, I have him for 67 yards, the toolbox.
But you got this big offensive line. Again, they really controlled that third quarter. Didn't score points on their opening drive, but had it for what? Over 7 minutes? Eight minutes? 7 minutes? And wondering if they're starting to wear things, wear them down in the trenches. Is Caldwell with the carry. And if you're Wrightstown, 5 minutes to go coming up, you're in no hurry to snap the ball.
Yeah, and this is where Wrightstown is at their best, Brett. You, in terms of like a primarily running offense, is able just to rattle off play after play and get the clock ticking.
Some crazy moments. You even think about that PAT, right? That PAT was good, offsides on Freedom. Wrightstown says, you know, we're going to send our offense onto the field, and instead of a tie game, now the Tigers lead by one and trying to finish this off. Thompson now in, and there's, guess who? Landon Helfrey inside the 40 to about the 39-yard line, third down. And a big moment again for this Freedom defense as under 4.5 minutes to play.
You know what my play is.
What's that?
Toolbox.
Well, he's getting the touches now, isn't he?
I mean, the guy falls forward. He's a rough kid. Tough kid, I should say. Let him power his way and secure that first down. Again, we're nearing the 4-minute mark in the fourth quarter.
Thompson with that glove on his left hand. Hands up. Whoa, watch out. There was a busted play. Thompson's able to hold on. Now you got fourth down.
Brett, that ball. He secured it, but it looked a little dicey
it
there for a
close.
Second.
It was close. I think Reed Roloff, number 52, senior defensive tackle, one of the guys in to wrap up Thompson. But here you go, fourth and one. Decision time for Coach Clister. Is he going to go for it, or is he going to punt it away and play field position?
That's a great question. You know, 3:35 and counting, Brett. You know, a punt here would really pin Freedom back.
But they've got the explosiveness to make that very manageable. But right now, it looks like Wrightstown offense on the field. Are they going to try to draw the Irish offsides? Or are they going to go for this? Let's see. Fourth down, Thompson under center, waiting for the snap. He's got it. And there's, not even a chase. Still on his feet, spinning away. Landon Helfrey again getting the ball, lowering those pads. Again, just not a target to wrap up. Those big, strong legs powering his way through, fighting off the first, second, third contact, and down to the 30, a big first down. Clock continues to run.
Yeah, Brett, I have a toolbox, 7 carries, 79 yards, but that might have been the most significant carry. Again, he's just on this drive. It was his first carries of the second half. Mm. 2:40 and counting now.
At some point, when does Freedom start burning timeouts?
Exactly.
As Thompson waiting again for the snap. Helfrey again. And I got to think Freedom's going to finally take a timeout, and it looks like the Irish will do just that.
Timeout, Freedom.
You know, Freedom's got to be tired of tackling him.
Yeah, and that big offensive line's getting off the snap right now too, winning at the line of scrimmage again. How long have they been out there this half? Really have possessed the ball, time of possession, a big advantage here for the Tigers in the second half. We got a score from Mike Sherry. You see, 42-14 now, Kimberly.
Oh yeah, that impressive win for them.
Still in the fourth.
Yeah, and well, I doubt East doesn't really have the kind of offense to come back from that many points down, Brett, but I mean, this is a Kimberly team that's had some nail biters this season, and more specifically against Fond du Lac last week. They came out, and that was an East team that's been ascending, so they took care of a business, Brett.
I'm guessing the papermakers are getting a little tired of that chatter.
Which particular one?
Second down coming, and oh, good run again. That's number 28, Caden Caldwell. Another first down for the Tigers. I'm thinking, Ricardo, that, the chat, ooh, East, you know, it's a big game, you know, and a lot of attention. And, boy, Kimberly had a hard time getting past Fond du Lac. I think Kimberly was saying, hey, we're still Kimberly.
Oh, yeah, definitely. I mean, that's a team that
I think that was the chatter.
I had no qualms, even after having the close one over Fond du Lac, I've had them number one.
Yeah, but
there was never a doubt in my mind.
I'm thinking there, with folks saying, ooh, this is a big game. This is an upset game. East is ascending. I think Kimberly said, no, that's not going to be the case today.
Well, I think both can be true, but I think this is about Kimberly playing their best game of the year so far.
I think they came ultra-focused, and it looks like we're going to get a flag. Is that going to be a delay game?
Brett.
Set on Wrightstown?
Yes, it is.
With a minute 46 to play, last thing you want to be doing is backing up when you're trying to run out the clock and finish this off. Look at Steve Clister, Ricardo, old school. He doesn't even wear a headset.
Yeah.
Thompson waiting for it again. There's Helfrey, and really don't have to do much. Freedom will take another timeout.
Timeout Freedom.
So both teams with a timeout remaining. Hey, Ricardo, tell everybody about what's coming up. I know how your weekend goes. You always have different articles that come out, right? Look, recapping that week's football games.
Hey, I'm just enjoying this LL Cool J Classic. Like, is that Coach Burbaton doing the DJing? Oh, that's okay. Baseball coach, Eric. But, it's been – I'm sorry, what was your question? I was getting down with LL
Cool
too, J.
You're too listening to music.
Oh, yeah, okay. Well, listen, Saturday – yeah, around 10-ish, 11-ish, we put out the Fox Valley Roundup, which this will be a lead story for the Fox Valley Roundup. And then we have a city-specific one for Appleton that does Appleton North, East, West, FEL, and Xavier. So, folks can check that out. I usually have it mid-morning Saturdays. So please check that out. You know, I try to track down some late quotes and maybe some stats early Saturday morning to complete those two pieces.
There you go. Always good reading. I always love reading the comments. It's Humphreys. Humphreys and Helfrey. I can sometimes get those mixed up. But always good reading. Like reading the comments as Freedom uses its final timeout. Don't have any update on that.
Fond du Lac, right?
Little Chute Luxembourg Casco score for the folks, for the NEC
I'll
fans
look for
out there.
Both here.
Anybody knows what's going on? Send me a tweet, PC Bretzi.
Ooh, it's a close game between Fond du Lac and Kalkana. Fond du Lac's up 27-24 with 7 minutes left.
Really?
Yep. And then was it Luxembourg Casco?
Luxembourg Casco and Little Chute. Luxembourg Casco led 21-7 at the half. Haven't seen an updated score then. That's obviously a game of interest to the fans here. If it holds and Luxembourg Casco wins and Wrightstown's able to put this one away, those two teams will be...
I haven't seen anything either. Ryan Wing, our TV friend, is there, but I haven't seen any other score from that, Brett.
Actually, check that. Wrightstown, that's a conference game last week against Xavier, right? That's a crossover game,
yes.
So that counts in the standings. So, yeah. FEL, the other undefeated team coming into tonight as far as NEC games go. So third down. And, again, Freedom now out of timeout. So you're just going to run this one.
Oh,
wow. Helfrey stays up.
Wow. I'm telling you.
Mm. That is a big-time hit. And now what do you do? You kick the field goal or you're just going to continue to run? You're going to let that clock run down. Tigers still have a timeout to use as well, so they can burn this as far down as they want to go.
I have
take that final timeout.
Yeah, I have 11 carries, 90 yards for the toolbox, Brett. Nice night for him. Some really important runs here down the stretch.
Tigers at the line of scrimmage as Thompson again filling in at quarterback here on this drive, waiting for the snap. Nope, he's taking his time.
Yep.
I think the Wrightstown going to burn that last timeout. Seeing if he could
draw them offsides, bring up a fourth and short.
And with what, 9.7 seconds to go? Oh, 49.7 seconds to go. Sorry, that's what the clock. 49.7 seconds to go. Our clock got pushed a little bit.
Yeah, I'm still trying to figure out why Vandehei is not out there.
Yeah, he looks okay.
Might have been a hand thing. I did see him looking at his hand.
Well, then we're bad luck because it seems like everywhere we go, quarterbacks are getting banged up.
Yeah, don't say that. It's a good question. Coach Verbaten here is asking, do they kick a field goal here or just run this out and see if it can come back? To me, I say you go for it. I say go for it. Yeah. Wrightstown's defense has been playing lights out this half. In that situation, you trust your defense and you trust – you know, your offense, maybe they can pull it out here, pull out the fourth and long.
Well, let's see what Thompson's going to do. And he hands off. It's going to be short. So Freedom gets the stop, but there's 44.6 seconds to go as we're trying to kind of remaneuver this clock. We apologize, folks. Rosie's working feverishly to get it back online for everybody.
Let me tell you something. That was a long drive for Wrightstown. It took the clock from 6:45 down to 44.6 seconds. So 5 minutes elapsed, Brett. Exactly what you needed if you're Wrightstown. You would have liked to have a score there, but this is the next best thing.
And think about that opening drive in the second half. So they've possessed the ball a ton this half. Well, Freedom just has to somehow get in field goal range, get no timeouts, and I think that was the right.
It is, actually.
Incomplete. Don't hold on to it. So I'm kind of wondering if Luke Talbot thought about it at the last second, said, I don't want to. We want an incompletion to keep this clock stopped. What a heck of a battle here in week five.
And if Freedom does take the L here, Brett, that's three straight losses, correct?
First time since 2010.
Oh, boy.
Definitely rare to see that as Quartz looking to his left, and he's sacked. He's dropped. That's number 72, it looks like. And check that. I'm sorry. Braden Nowitzki. and Sam Coyler. Watch out again, Quartz. And now you're down to your final play. Very disjointed there with 20.3 seconds to go.
20.3 seconds left. As that Wrightstown defense is imploring its crowd to get loud here.
Ball at the 13-yard line.
It's going to take a miracle here if you're Freedom.
Quartz, again looking left, gonna fire, and right through the fingertips, and Wrightstown's gonna pull this one out, Ricardo.
First down, Wrightstown!
Nina beats Oshkosh West, 42-20, by the way.
Yeah, impressive win for Wrightstown here, Brett. They were able to overcome some, you know, kind of, they shot themselves in the foot a few times here, did Wrightstown, and they were able to get things together when they absolutely needed it. Dominated that second half in terms of possession, and then that final drive to really erase 5 minutes plus was fantastic.
That drive to open the second half set the tone.
Yes,
They didn't get points out of it, but it set the tone for them. They were able to kind of get that running game going again, and I thought Vandehei had some decent throws as well.
And Coach Klister going for it on two, going for the two-point conversion.
Yeah.
Very critical as well.
And there it is, your final tonight as we look at our CelCom Cooney's Embroidery and Sportswear scoreboard. It was a thriller, and they always are in the Northeastern Conference, it seems like, regardless of who we're streaming. Wrightstown pulls it out, 15-14. Heck of a battle here tonight at Wrightstown High School, week five game in the books. I know, Ricardo, you had some thoughts about how that one went.
First off,
how about from the Freedom vantage point?
Well, for Freedom, three straight losses. I'm gonna ask Jaden, what do you do? I mean, you're 0-3 right now in the NEC. You know, it's imperative that they get going on the other side of the win column, right? You gotta start winning some games if you want to make the playoffs. The season's quickly coming to an end.
Well, Ricardo, they have Luxembourg, Casco, Little Chute, Denmark, and FVL all
yes.
on the schedule still.
Ouch.
Those are all good teams.
Yes, and a couple of those teams have been fighting for that NEC lead. So, Brett, okay, so what do? You've been playing well at times. Now it's about let's pull off the tape. What are we doing well and what are we doing wrong? Are those correctable mistakes? I think they are in some respects. And, you know, Coach Jaden, this is his first year. Little bit of a challenge here now.
Some adversity now,
A little
right?
bit of adversity. And but that's a proud program, Brett, that's had a lot of success, you know, the last 15 years or so. Now for Wrightstown, big win for them. They're coming off the loss. How would you respond? Was it a clean game? No, but in the second half when they absolutely had to, they dominated time of possession.
Got back to doing what
yes,
they do, right?
Timely plays on defense, right? The toolbox getting that knockaway on that fourth down play, that was big. And then to come back and take time off the clock, get that touchdown, the drive previous, and go for the two-point conversion. I think this is a pretty well-played second half for Wrightstown in terms of doing what you needed to do to get out of here with the win on homecoming.
On homecoming night to boot. So they'll be celebrating in downtown Wrightstown tonight. Not us. We got to break down some gear and get the heck out of here. But good work, Ricardo, as always.
Yeah, good work for you too. And
maybe not.
I won't see you, but you know, it'll be the me or Mike Sherry. Either way, you'll be happy.
Yep. Well, yeah, we'll be happier with Mike.
I know you will be.
No, we won't. We'll miss you. We'll miss you.
All right, guys. Have a good one.
So good job, Ricardo. Appreciate it. Thank you, Craig. Appreciate it. That was Craig Hayes, the athletic director here. Always appreciate him and his staff. They do a great job here. All our schools do, though. We have great respect and relationships with everybody here in the Fox Valley, Northeast Wisconsin. Let me run down the scoring, though, before we sign off. And we got to look for our wagon, Rosie. Somewhere our wagon is. I think it's down there. I see it down there. It's still here, Rosie. Don't worry about it. The wagon is okay. Let me run down the scoring. As I said, Freedom got on the scoreboard first. 10:31 to go in the second quarter. A 25-yard pass from Drew Quartz to Carson Clausen. It was kind of tipped by a Wrightstown defender, and Clausen was able to secure it in the end zone, made it 7-0 Freedom. Wrightstown answered on a 37-yard run by Landon Helfrey with 5:15 to play. Tied it up at 7 apiece, broke a few tackles, and then barreled his way into the end zone from there. And then right at the end of the half, as time expired, a 14-yard pass from Quartz to number 18, Noah Heinke, It's an off-schedule play. Courts was on the run and was able to get it out to Heinke, who then zigged and zagged his way in, danced his way into the end zone. And he actually set that up with a 50-yard interception return. So Heinke doing it on both both defense and offense, and it was 14-7 at the half. The only score in the second half came with 9:31 to play in the fourth quarter. A one-yard touchdown run by Aiden Humphreys. And then Wrightstown actually kicked the extra point, but there was an offsides call on the play against Freedom. So head coach Steve Clister said, you know what, we're going to put our offense back onto the field. And they were able to convert it on the two-point conversion. Caden Caldwell with the run again with 9:31 to play, made it 15-14 Wrightstown. And that's how the score ends with a victory. The 10th-ranked Tigers, that's ranked 10th in Division 5 in this week's with Sports.net State Coaches Poll. Wrightstown improves to 4-1 on the season, 2-1 in Northeastern Conference play. Tigers are at Denmark on Friday in a Northeastern Conference matchup. Kickoff is scheduled for 7 p.m. Freedom now 2-3 on the season, 0-3 in league play. As I mentioned, first time since 2010 that the Irish have lost three straight. So we'll see if the Irish can get it turned around. Tough one, though, next Friday night, home against Luxembourg Casco. That's a Northeastern Conference matchup. Kickoff is scheduled for 7 p.m. And at last check, Luxembourg Casco was beating Little Chute 21-7. Of course, that was a halftime score. We haven't seen anything updated since then. As for us, we're not sure where we're going to be. Again, I'll announce it on my Twitter account, at PCBretzy, so please give me a follow. And you can always access our previous Game of the Week live streams on our USA Today Network Wisconsin websites. Just go to the sports section, scroll down until you see the Watch Our Varsity Game of the Week prep live streams link. Once again, thanks to our sponsors, Cellcom and Cooney's Embroidery and Sportswear. Cellcom's great smartphone event is going on now through October 1st. Get up to $900 when you activate a new line. Savings available on a variety of phones, including top brands. Visit cellcom.com/save for details. And Cooney's, they have the skills and experience to customize your apparel and spread the word about your organization. Contact them today at 920-731-0922. Or send them an email, Cooneys, C-O-O-N-E-Y-S, 0922 at sbcglobal.net. So for Rosie, for Ricardo and the crew with USA Today Network Wisconsin, I'm Brett Christopherson saying so long from Wrightstown High School. Once again, the final score, great Week 5 matchup. Wrightstown takes down Freedom 15-14. Thanks for watching, everybody.